inside the skin of our teeth, ladies and gentlemen. It's still just barely 420 by the skin of our teeth, quite literally here. Good to get it in. Light them if you got them. Somebody's playing that in the background. I don't know where that was coming from, but we're good now. Hey, what up, everybody? It's me, Craig X, in the place to be, which is Studio 710, for kind of a Christmassy episode. I know the last couple of years I've done it in the whole Santa getup and shit, but you can't interview the dog pound dressed as Santa unless you're like a Superfly Santa. But that's just not gangster. So anyway, we're still here though. We're doing it. In case you didn't know, yes, it's going to be a big, big show here. Episode 115 of the award-winning Expert Joints Live. Thanks for tuning in this week. And of course, everybody who tuned in last week, I also appreciate you doing that. Who was it? We had Andrew from 91 Supreme, Mike and Tennille from Miss Envy, D420K, Courtney Made It, and Al the Alchemist. It was dope. Check the replay after this. Also, chat everybody who's tuned in right now, Chillin' Like a Villain, John Fan, Lyle Ketchum, Frisco Bright, Calyx Union, What's Going On, John Rocks. And yes, whoever the two people are have already given me a thumbs down. Hey, show hasn't even started. Well, I appreciate the fact that you're still watching, even if you're not liking it. You're still watching it. The rest of you, give it a thumbs up and we can counteract the percentages. Anyway, like you say, no pleasing some folks. Mics are low. Andrew will be dialing that up and tweaking that as we go. Thank you for the heads up. They're chilling like a villain. He's very particular about his sound. Anyway, on with the show. This week we're going to kick off the Kickdown. That's the name of the show, the Kickdown Kickoff. The philanthropic event that I'll be hosting a little later this evening over at Fortune Sound Club, featuring a bunch of the West Coast finest. Hey, there's a couple of the West Coast finest right there. Yes, we've got the finest MCs and some of the finest cannabis. To that end, some of the entertainers and sponsors are going to be on the show today, including some of the performers, aka almost all of the performers, which is really fucking cool, including from the Dog Pound, the DPG legend himself, Daz Dillinger, in the place to be. Diggity Daz, Studio 710. What? Also, the traveling tour DJ of the People Northwest, gonna be Temple of Calyx. Toe a little wreaths on there, the little over here. See, we got repping it, holding it down. Speaking of Temple of Calyx, we'll be smoking some of their products shortly as well, too, with our good friend, the Saltwater Cowboy, Tim McBride, who I'm sure can use a fucking joint like nobody's business right now. My man's been traveling for about 12 hours, should be here any minute. Got the message saying he's in the car on the way, so that's super cool. We're also going to puff pass it along, a whole bunch of products to give away this month. It's a sort of Christmassy sort of bonus. You don't get it before Christmas probably, but still a Christmas present, so what are you going to do? To start the show, before the show, again, hosting tonight's show from the other Pot TV show, he's been waiting to dab this dab, ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Al the Alchemist, at peace with
Hi.
David Suzuki for at least another couple weeks.
Another couple days.
Days.
You know, it's like
Tuesday, it's on.
Yeah, it's fucking on. Right. It's on like Donkey Kong.
Also
Suzuki.
On is this evening the Kickdown.
The Kickdown together. Is on this evening.
Oh, man.
Oh, man.
Big night tonight, bud.
Huge night tonight.
Daz Dillinger, Max Sean 100, Salam Rec, Creed Taylor, People Northwest, and the late additions, Checkmate and Concise even added to the bill.
And Ernie Woodlow.
And Early Woodlow. All at Fortune Sound Club. Going to be a hell of a show. I appreciate you bringing all these talented folks together tonight, my friend.
I appreciate all of these fucking talented folks coming together because everybody's got a choice to do something or not.
Right.
Right. So I got to give like huge, huge shout out to Daz Dillinger, Salam Rec, Max Sean 100, Big A, Dog Pound.
Everybody making it happen.
J-Wan Agency.
Fortune rolling it out.
Fortune Sound Club, Blueprint Events. Holy shit, Blueprint Events has been instrumental in helping me through this whole thing. It's been a humbling learning experience.
And a bit of a pain in the ass.
Well, I mean, all things new start off as a pain in the ass because we don't know them, right?
Right, well, we know that you know your cannabis. And we know that this event is going to be a good one tonight. So I'm glad you brought together Terpfire, Tepla Calyx, and MMJ, and all sorts of the different sponsors who were all involved. It's going to be a fun event, but it's also a philanthropic event as well, too. You're trying to raise a little bit of money as well, as we've talked about. Can you give us the kind of rundown, like what the plan is for any of the funds raised?
Well, first and foremost, we're going to try to kick down as much as we can to the Salvation Army Society. Just because they're the fucking OGs. They've been doing it so long.
Since been doing it.
They've been super reputable. They help so many people. So we're going to do that. We already started the other day with buying a shit whack of socks and handing them out down in the downtown east side.
On a wet ass day too.
That practice is going to continue throughout, you know, throughout the season. It's not just a one shot thing. Every few days, every super, you know, the really cold, wet days, I'm going to be out there. Maybe I'll have a team with me, but I'm going to be out there for sure, passing that shit out.
Man. Well, we're going to be passing around some blunts tonight at Fortune Sound Club.
Oh, boy. Hey, Salam Rek taught me how to roll a blunt today.
I saw that. Oh, the third time's a charm.
Yeah. As long as I don't do the blunt cracking,
yeah, you're good.
I can roll the shit out of a blunt.
Yeah, they practically roll themselves right back up.
I need a professional blunt cracker, so I just don't got to do it.
Chilling Like a Villain noticed the Corey piece on the
Sublimator.
Yeah. Right now.
Now, here's another crazy thing. As Sublimator has evolved, yes. You know, I mean, like, come on, let's be honest here.
The Dabmaster 2.0, it's titanium Dabmaster right there.
Has evolved in their design and aesthetics. I thought, you know what, it's fucking time we put some heady fucking glass on this thing.
That's a heady man.
So for a couple years, Corey and I have been, you know, discussing a project, and Corey finally had time to attack this project, and with his brilliant mind, we have the Orbic Elevator.
No. With your brilliant mind, what I think is really cool is all those people who are coming out to the event tonight, save their ticket stuff, can go down to MMJ after the event and get some free weed, right?
We want to kick back.
Kicking back,
you know,
at
we're
the
kicking back to people. You know, it's a fucking super special thing today.
It's the holiday season. People,
well, no, it's beyond. It's the solstice today.
As well.
And not just the solstice, but we have Saturn in Capricorn, which makes fucking magic.
Wait, are they on the show too? Andrew, do we have enough mics for
Saturn
and Capricorn?
They do everything telepathically.
Oh, thank God, because I didn't know where
that's
we were going to put
that's just a
vibe
them. That gets sent out.
I thought we needed stools or something.
So as we're coming up on one of the darkest days of the year, darkest day of the year.
It's going to be one of the brightest and lightest days of the year.
The powers of Saturn in Capricorn and the Sun in Capricorn create really fucking serious magic. So tonight's kind of about new beginnings too. You know, it's about birthing some new things and setting new ventures into play. So I encourage everybody, if you're feeling you need to make a change, fucking do it tonight. Seriously.
And
write that shit down. You don't even have to do the action. You write that shit down and you make a fucking physical proclamation and you end that with so mote it be, and it will.
Well, man, you embrace that dab. I'm going to suggest one more time, come out to the kickdown tonight. I also going to embrace some of this fine product from the Temple of Calyx here tonight. What am I about to put under the camera over here? I grabbed something from this bag over here. Got some Hindu, maybe?
Hindu Kush.
Could very
got
well
some
be.
Crack.
Oh,
wow.
Shit.
Big ass dab. I'm going to finish that.
Yeah, you take that dab, and I'm going to put this sucker in the bud cam here and go zoom. And while I do this and roll up with the show, I appreciate you bringing us some bud, and I appreciate you stopping by.
I appreciate you.
Man, I'm going to be.
Appreciate all of you out there. And
appreciate
get up
this
Sound
bud porn.
It's going to be bomb. Daz Dillinger doing a Daz and Mataz album release party.
Man, I love it.
Boom!
Well, we'll smoke some of these products at that. Why don't you go get Daz while I...
Let's go get those guys.
You go get those guys while I roll up this over here. Andrew, that's my... Yeah, there you go. And you got to do the mic swap. You go get the talent. And I will roll up this weed brought to you by the Temple of Calyx. For more, visit Temple of Calyx on Instagram or stop by an MMJ Canada location near you. Good place to get it as any. Also, they're sponsors tonight of the event. So we'll just take a second here while we bring in our next couple of guests. I roll the joint. I guess I could move a little bit of it just off to the side for a sec so you could see me roll some of it. And I say to you, thank you very much, Chilling Like a Villain. We did a little Christmas decorations literally at the last second. So put up a couple little decks. Like I said, no Santa suit this year, but that's okay. That's okay. I got a few little set decks. We got some stockings. Parker got his stocking. Parker was around somewhere, but he seems to have fucked off for a minute. But that's okay. I got this Temple of Calyx, Hindu Kush to keep me warm, keep me company. It's fine. And I'm about to have a whole bunch of guests.
who, well, we've duffed the timing of it ever so slightly. But as I stall, because, you know, rappers take a minute to motivate. Here, rappers. Come on now, MCs. Put down the blunt. Come into the studio, gentlemen. No, it's all good. They had a long day. They just came back from the in-store meet and greet at MMJ. And hopefully those mics are almost on and they will be in here soon. Oh, I hear it. Yep, I hear people coming. Yep. Are they ready? Yeah, we waiting. I can't stall anymore. It's got the thumbs up, they're mic'd up and ready. So probably best known as one half of the Dog Pound. Nope, not yet. Okay. Hey, like my poinsettia, it's big. You can't really see me. I got a lot of stuff on the desk here. Holy crap, do I have a lot of stuff on the desk here. Al?
Yo.
Are they coming?
Yeah, they're coming.
Perfect. Everyone's sitting here waiting in suspense. There we go. Hey.
Hey.
Probably best known as one half of the Dog Pound. He's also a legendary producer responsible for so many of your all-time favorites. Please welcome to the show, my man, Daz Dillinger. Also, he's collaborated with the likes of Tupac Shakur, Snoop Dogg, E-40, The Dog Pound, and many more, hailing from Vallejo, California.
Hey.
Max Shaw 100.
And you do
And also
that.
Coming in as well, two we in a second here. And an MC is only as good as his DJ. His DJ is good, so please welcome to the show, DJ producer, the one and only Salam Rek. Ladies and gentlemen, Max Shaw and Daz Dillinger,
and Parker.
Salam Rek. I'm a man, Parker.
Parker.
Dogs for the Dog Pound.
High five, Parker.
Big Parker
wants a snack, okay?
God damn, he likes carrots, right. Y'all, and you do know that.
Look at him.
They know that.
He likes a lot.
Gentlemen, first of all, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Honor
and
pleasure to have all y'all on the show.
Pleasure's all ours. And you do know that. Thank you,
well,
Craig X. Craig X. Thank you, champ.
That I want to make any of us too sound too old or whatever, but you know, we've been all been around this game for 25 years or so or more doing what we've been doing. And
this is true. This is true.
I mean, I got to ask, Daz, first thing to start out, you look back at those times from back then.
Oh, yeah.
And did you kind of ever really think that I would be here 25, almost 30 years later, fucking still making music and
getting grams off your table?
Exactly. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I just thank the Lord that I'm still here to do what I am here sent to do, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And that's give you a legacy of great music, you know what I'm saying? And just being a great person that I am, you know, and I'm just happy to be here, you know?
Man, I love it. Speaking of great music, of course, you've done some of the biggest tracks in hip-hop history. You worked on some of the biggest labels with some of the biggest names.
I reached the pinnacle of rap.
Pretty fucking close, homie. I mean, to put it on like that, it is.
I am. You know, I got videos freestyling with Biggie and Tupac.
Right.
Who else got that?
Well, not to sit there and talk all about Tupac or any Death Row stuff too much, but you produced some of the biggest and most classic records that cat ever really did. You know what I mean?
So, yeah.
So it is what it is, man. And then, I mean, cats like yourself, I mean, Max Shawn, we know you did your Funk Mob project, but you've been collaborating, I think I count more than 75, 80 different fucking joints and shit you've crossed over with people on. It's crazy.
Right. Well, I've been on numerous of records and collaborated with a lot of artists. Almost about 150 albums to be exact to date, right? One of my first platinum records was me and the legendary E-40 record called I'm Riding Sideways, Way, That Way. That was Max Shine, E-40, and Be Legit. And that was off Earl's album, In a Major Way. And so, you know, and I had the group called the Funk Mob, of course. Had a couple of solo albums. So I've just been steady putting paint where it ain't. And, you know, continue to get the people good music because they want it, you know. The people is what motivate me. So as long as they keep asking, we're going to keep giving it to them and being creative about it, right?
Well, as a creative force, and, you know, the DJ is always trying to, control the flow, rock the crowd. I mean, you have to have seen, obviously, quite the evolution in music from when you first got into it, Salam, to today's, you know, so-called hip-hop or trap music, or whatever the music is changing. I mean, how do you feel the progress or the evolution? What's your thoughts
on that? I love it. I love how the music has grown. From when I first was a kid and hearing all the records and listening to NWA and listening to these guys and Ice Cube and them, and then watching how it is now. I like the new records that they do now. You know what I'm saying? I like all that stuff. I like the 808s. I like the slaps. I play all that stuff. You know what I'm saying? Every Sunday, Secret Sesh. Come check me out.
So when we look back at it and you listen back to before Big Daddy and Rakim and the music styles, how it went, when they came, boom, we switched that. We go through the golden era. We all been through what y'all did. And we see the evolution. But that's nothing really new. I mean, music and art continues to evolve always.
Yeah, it's a cycle. If you paid attention, like back in the day, Beastie Boys, even Big Daddy Kane, all them records, they was using 808s.
Right.
Run DMCs, they was using all them kind of sounds.
Right.
Now, this music has grown to what it is now. You know what I'm saying? People start trying to
808 rolling drummers.
Everybody trying to pigeon toe stuff, like all the new stuff and the old stuff. Man, it's all of it together. You know what I'm saying?
Look at that Paul's Boutique album, man. That thing didn't come into its own until years after.
See? You know and it mean? Grew in on people. Right? It grows on people. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes people do records that are ahead of their time. But well, you know, music is music and it stays around forever. I call music real estate because it never goes nowhere. You'll be dead, but the music's still gonna be here.
Right?
Please believe that. Music never dies.
Well, let me get into that.
It's forever rolling.
Let's start with the man in the middle. First question is, how and when did you get into hip hop, Big Dog?
How did I get into hip hop?
Yeah, when did you start? Where did that journey start?
Oh, man, you know, just being black, man, and hanging around, you know, gang members and cousins and aunties, and you know, just. Grew up first off
of
Slick Rick.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Slick Rick, NWA, Run DMC, just a fan of hip hop, learning how to beatbox. And
what was the first instrument that you got your hands on? I'm curious to know that myself.
A keyboard. My mother played the piano in church, you know what I'm saying? Just all that, but just me stealing some turntables. Shout out to Calvin from VIP. You know, I admit that I took those turntables.
Now, all these years later, when the statute of limitations expired, how many instruments do you play?
About two or three. I picked through it, but my daughter, she played fluently, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Jasmine.
So this is it brings a beautiful point there, a lovely segue, almost like you planned it, but your daughter, the musical genes are flowing nicely through.
Yeah.
Now, let me break all this down here, okay? So you touched on E-40, Mac, that's your cousin.
Right.
But you also cousins with Ice Cube.
True.
Daz, if I'm not mistaken, and the legends are true, you and Snoop are cousins.
Yeah.
And then, wait, now, my man down there, Fred Wreck, is also your brother, who's produced for Snoop and shit.
Yeah, that's my big brother.
Okay. All in the family.
So this is what I'm saying, man. First of all, you must have had the most talented, like, Christmas pageants and shit like that as kids, or playing around in the streets, or whatever you did for family on Christmas get-togethers, man.
We used to do, you know, Black History Month, where we get up in church and be like, "Hi, I'm Muhammad Ali."
Right,
doing plays and whatnot. And then, on another note, my mother was a musical wizard. You know what I mean? My mother, Ms. Dorothy Leonard, was a lady that probably had over 2,000 records in the 70s. So the music game in us came before it was rap.
I was going to say, are there aunts and uncles and parents who set all this for you guys?
Of course, I get my music background from my mother and father.
Right.
Because they were so musically drenched. Not just musically drenched in the house, but at church as well.
The culture, you raised
in
that environment.
Same with my parents. In church too.
Yeah, my pops, he can play guitar, he can play cornet, trumpet. My dad now is still playing instruments. He just learned clarinet. He'd be at home making his own reeds. Playing
no, that's
this day,
crazy.
My dad's 70 years old, you know what I'm saying? He still does instruments to this day, so that's where I got out. We used to have all the trumpets and stuff laying around, and me and my brothers used to just pick them up and start going at it.
You can't have water without weed or weed without water.
Right? You do know that.
I love my BC Bud, by the way.
Well, and we wouldn't have had...
Shout out to Van City, baby.
We wouldn't have had the music we had and the change in the history that we had if it wasn't for your family to get to you, and then all the work that you've done, and obviously you're passing on, but... My next question, I guess, then, is sort of, where did it come from? Like, you know, Krupp isn't here or whatever, but how did you guys connect and the Dog Pound come together?
I mean, you know, Snoop, my cousin, and, you know, was just hanging out, and, you know, Corrupt and Snoop was battling, and, you know, we all became one family, and we started just doing records with Warren G, and Warren G was Dr. Dre's brother, and
right.
Hooked us up with you know, NWA and all that, and then we started feuding with NWA, and
yeah,
and then we got with Dr. Dre, Suge Knight, and it became Death Row Records,
which was kind of the big deal, a little bit. Death Row Records made a little bit of its own noise.
All the time, you know what I'm saying? And still going on to the day. There's so many
right
theories and shows going on, you know what I'm saying? But I got the real story, you know, because everybody want to tell
you got the
story.
Real story plus the real glory.
Yeah.
And you do know that.
Well, you were there to live it. And yeah, of course, I'm not going to sit here and necessarily call you on the spot because I don't do hard-hitting investigative journalism. Me neither.
I'm not the police.
Right? But, yeah, obviously there's been some recent shows on, and you were on it, and all the features. Everybody's got their stories to say, man. You know, 20-some years later, here we are, though. Important part is people are still talking about the man who you guys all worked closely with and knew, and I'm sure things would be a lot different if he still would have been around, but for all of us. But we're still here. We're doing it. And after all the dust has settled with all the drama that went down, we're now to the point where we're making new music, we're moving forward ahead, we're continuing to collaborate, and we got new projects on. And of course, you're doing a show tonight, The Kickdown.
Oh, hell boy. Yeah. In Van City, baby.
You know, I got a new album coming out, Dazzle and Taz, 2018. You know what I'm saying? Got a slew of videos. We're going to play a couple of videos here, like Bang Bang, featuring my cousin B Legit, cousin Big Gip from the Goody Mob, you know what I'm saying? And we in Vallejo, you know what I'm saying? Having a real good time.
Well, we got a few of those videos, queued up. We'll get to those in a second. But I got to ask you, man, do you enjoy rapping or producing more? Or is it all the same kind of?
It's all the same to me. I love it all.
Yeah.
You can't walk without talking and talking without walking, right?
And can you just for one time clarify before we do the video that we have permission to use it, YouTube? And when
YouTube, you got permission to use this. You know what I'm saying? If
please,
I'm here, this permission is granted.
There you go. So when I get hit with the copyright strike and I appeal it, I'm going to timestamp this. And the man who gave me the video and said I could play the video is right here.
Yeah, right here. So you know you motherfuckers, Leo Korn. You better get it together, motherfucker.
Right?
Get it together.
You ain't called, motherfucker.
Well, you know.
Don't let us get you. Yes, well, we need those chips with dip. With dip. Okay.
I want to know, Salaam, how did you end up getting together, working on the road touring with all these guys? I mean, I know you worked with D12 and Eminem. And
he was a fugitive and he broke out. That's where I started. Come over here and DJ for us.
He needed a ride on the bus.
I grew up with Em and all them guys, and that's where I started from with Marshall and everybody. And at the same time, you know, if you don't know, a lot of the Dog Pound and Snoop families, they're from Detroit. You know, Papa Snoop, he was always in Detroit. Nate Dogg was always hanging out in Detroit. Dad's mama, she used to live in Detroit. So they used to be out there all the time visiting. And when they used to come visit, they used to come kick it with me.
I used to come over to his house. He stayed right off the freeway.
You know what I'm saying? Dad used to come over to my house right off of 8 Mile and come kick it. I used to have the liquor store across the street and call me the Habibi. You know, my cousin Sam, he called me and he says, man, you owe somebody some money, man? There's some big old black guys on your porch.
Oh, wow.
I'm like, what?
Can
I
go
pull up and the homies and be over there hanging out? So, you know, I grew a relationship, and as well as my brother, you know what I'm saying? He was producing and stuff with them. So, you know, when we was kids, I used to go sit with, like, Roscoe while these guys would go do shows. I used to have to wait in a hotel room. And you know what I'm saying? So as I started growing up and doing shows and going on tours, next thing you know, me and Em and everybody, we started being on the same tours. We'd like Snoop, we was doing Rock the Mic tour stuff and all that. And I went out to the West Coast and moved out there, and Daz was like, man, come on, let's go rock these shows. And we've been rocking them ever since.
And you
guys done some tracks together and stuff. You had the joint earlier this
went up
year.
There.
Hell yeah.
Right. Went out there, he produced a track with me and Obi Trice on my
BPG. Only on the left side.
Yeah, only on the left side.
Right? I mean, you guys are working together for so long, and actually you touched on something, on some around the way shit. Now, Max Young.
Talk to me.
I don't want to kind of put you on blast or incriminate anything live on the air or nothing like that, but it's talking about people showing up at houses and shit like that. Old rap legend goes, and maybe you can defer to this, or maybe you want to comment, I don't know. But legend says that Biggie and E-40 had a little beef, and I guess it's his cousin. You might notice
your name right
this.
In a minute.
Oh, wow.
And story goes along the way that you were the man who actually kind of shut that beef down. Is it like, I don't want to put on some hood shit live on Pod TV, but are you comfortable like addressing any of these or dispelling a legend or a myth?
You know what, Craig X, you know you're my brother and I love you so much and I can't do nothing but keep it real.
Okay.
This
then.
Is true. Yeah, I was that guy to surround Biggie Smalls limo. And have a conversation with Biggie and to check and to make sure things was all right.
With Earl.
A little frank conversation with Frank White.
Earl was at home in the bed.
Okay, so 40 was, 40 was sleeping at like 2 in the morning or some shit.
I got Earl on the phone. You know, matter of fact, I didn't even have a cell phone. And, you know,
paged him back in the
crowd gave me a phone, and, you know. And so B, you know, he had said something in a magazine that, well, actually, it was a magazine that misprinted how it came to be. That he said, yeah, I don't mess with the E40 and the Clicks and the Max Time and the Two Shorts and the, you know, and the West Coast Boys. And I happened to have a concert in Sacramento, California at the time. And, you know, we catch him out there. After he come off the stage, we come to the back. I surround the limo. We pull a big chopper out. Say, what's happening, nigga? Right?
You know, it's a legitimate question.
I mean, it's what it is. It's not a secret. Lil C's, I love him to death. Shout out to Junior Mafia. Them was my folks. Because right after that, we got high, we smoked, and I drove them to the freeway. I also put Usalama around them. I put security around them to make sure it didn't nobody come in and try to infiltrate and do no harm to them, you know, to them dudes. You know, after we seen that it wasn't an issue,
yeah,
I put protection around them guys.
You got the pack.
Usalama!
You got the stamp from the neighborhood.
Shout out to local stamp. The whole Junior Mafia, Lil Kim and everything, it was my folks. P. Diddy from the Big City, you know I love y'all. You did. Man. They love Max Shine and E40, so that was just a little situation. But that was me to check the temperature.
Wow, man. Stories and legends that come out
man,
of the Bay
Area.
Man,
you heard about that, Craig,
man. Come on, man. I am the expert, B. Don't
right,
you know
is OG,
these things,
Craig,
man.
Right. That's
old,
right, Craig,
I am
Mac.
Old school, man.
You Craig Mack is OG. You know that.
Actually, and of course, we know lots of stuff that comes out of the Bay Area. Like the term 420 came from San Rafael High School right across the way
do.
From
you.
So
know that.
We know this, man.
Yes, sir.
I can't wait, man. There's so many questions I could ask, and I'd love to keep you guys all night, but I know that we do have to kind of let you get the sound check so pretty soon. So,
right.
Daz, give us the rundown on the album, the new album. Can you give us, like, how the project came about and maybe a little list of some of the features
man.
On it?
You know what I'm saying? Like, new album, Daz and the Taz, produced by me, 32 songs, and, you know, and we're just going to have fun. We're shooting videos, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to Big Gip out there in Atlanta. We got a group me and him called ATLA. You know what I'm saying? So y'all could be checking that out, man. We got the new video, One Day at a Time, out right now, me and Gip. You know, I shot that in the snow. It was snowing like this out there. So
right.
I caught that in the second of a time before it melted.
Nice, clean look.
Snowing in Atlanta.
You know what I mean?
What's going on?
Andrew, do you have that snowy video available?
Yes.
We got the page up, and we took a guess at 2 or 3 videos.
Yeah, it was the one with the white video, One Day at a Time.
Yeah?
Right.
Maybe we can play that in a second here.
Yeah,
let him find that, and we'll get the thumbs up. And he's pretty smart. He'll find
just
it
put
in there somewhere.
ATLA, Gip and Daz.
Hey, man, I really like your studio, man. This is a real nice place,
thank
man.
You, man. I appreciate
and,
it.
And I just thank you,
you
guys
got it?
For all the hospitality, man.
Hell yeah, man. Thank you.
No doubt,
just put
man.
Gip.
Hey, shout out to Expert Joints, man.
G-I-P-P.
Right shout out to Expert
Daz.
Joints. 710 Studio.
And you'll see the one with the
Todd
snow.
Todd is in the building. Craig X is in the building.
No, it's right called One Day at a Time.
Tonight, Fortune Sound.
Because you know, you got to take it one day at a time, dog.
Right? So, if you want to, I mean, it's a perfect drop. We've been talking about it. We take it one day at a time. Why don't we do it back then? I come back, ask a couple more questions.
Let's do it, man.
Let's do that, baby.
Andrew, whenever you're ready,
B. Take us to the video.
Take us to the video. This is One Day at a Time, produced by Kool Dollar, right here, ATLA. You hear me? You
Van City, Canada, stand up.
And Andrew is the multitasking master.
When the world stops, when the world stops, when the world stops, there you go, when the world stops. Now when the world stops spinning, if you lose or you're winning, when you realize, tell me what you got,
what you got.
Now when your girl stop tripping, when you're smiling and you're grinning, think it is, but it ain't, but it's not.
But it's
oh,
not.
I get high,
so high,
one day at a time,
and
let shit pass by. One day at a time,
yeah.
time.
Be empathetic and kind, baby, I'm understanding.
Whoop, hang on. Whoop.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Where's it go?
We're back now.
We threw too much at the system for a second and it freaked out a second. I think Andrew is resetting it, trying one more again. The video is just too fire, man. It messed with our gear for a second.
Sorry, we did
kind of spring it on Andrew.
I think it's too much smoke in here.
Could be.
We can't see the button to play.
All right. Well, when he gets that sorted, it's restarting. Okay. So while that restarts and we get at that for a second again, there, man, people are gonna be able to get the album on iTunes.
They're gonna get it on iTunes everywhere. You can go to my site, dogpound.com. I'm going to be selling it personally, so you can hit me up and you can get it autographed personally.
Oh, shit.
So,
Max Sean, I know you got all these projects going on with the big homie Snoop.
Well, you know what it is. I got a new record getting ready to come out with Snoop. I had the record for a while, but I never released it, you know. We say we're going to do it now. It's called So Fly, So Wet, and it's maybe be out in about 60 days, but also have Smoke the Best online, Max Sean 140. Go get it. All digital outlets, and you do know that.
Right.
Yeah, that's out now, online. Go fetch that, and you do know that.
Big collaborations, projects coming up. Salam, I know you're always working on something.
I got a single out with the Dog Pound. It's called Fuck It. You can get that right now on iTunes, out on Empire. I'm on a TV show right now, SBS Korea. It's called The Traveler's Guide to My Room. You can go watch the episodes. It's Aaron right now, me and Scoop DeVille. Shout out to Scoop DeVille. That's on TV. And
yeah, I got to ask that for a second. So you know Stranger, like Be Real TV, you did years on that. Pot TV might be your first time, but you know these weed web shows are cool with you. But Korean, like, programming, dog? How did that come about, son?
I went out to Korea to do a show, and when I was out there to do a festival, I was telling one of the guys, and the manager was like, yo, they should have a camera crew just follow us around, because it's kind of a culture shock. Because when you go to different countries like that, people don't really, you know, experience it. So I went and shot a little thing out there while we was out there, and it ended up getting like a million views. So the main TV station out there, SBS Korea, came in, and they were like, hey, man, we want to put you guys on a TV show. So I was like, fuck it, me and Scoop did it. We did a room swap. So one of the most famous comedians over there, her name is Nare Park. We went and stayed at her crib, and she went and stayed at our crib in L.A., and we did for like two weeks, we were staying there, and we got, you know, taped the whole time, 24 hours. Mics and everything. So that's on TV right now. The Traveler's Guide to My Room, SBS TV. Let's go check it out.
I think you can get the link off of your Instagram page, which is Salam Rec.
Yep, you can get the link. You can just throw it into Google. It'll pop up.
Right?
Yep.
Andrew, we getting any progress anywhere?
Shouts out to Kansas City, Canada. Shouts out to my boy Big Al at Classes and Sessions 666. Shouts out to Craig X.
Thank you.
Shouts out to Jay at Wine Agency. And go follow at MaxShine 100 at all digital outlets. And you do know that.
Right. That's Salam Rec across social media. MaxShine 100. MaxShine 100 across social media, the.coms, the Daz Dillinger, also the Dog Pound, the Dog Pound.
Yeah, THA, you already know.
The Dog Pound, if you will.
Yeah,
dot com.
The.
Instead of V, the. Yeah,
the Dog Pound.
The Dog Pound. You know it. Type in DPG, it'll come up. As well, too, is new videos coming out.
A ton of new videos coming up, man.
Yeah, you can do like 30 of them.
I'm shooting 32 videos.
Hey, shout out to all the smokers out there, you know what I'm saying? Everybody that's pushing medical marijuana. Everybody
that's
pushing that good, clean
street dope.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to everybody that's pushing the movement right there.
Everybody that's hustling.
All my family in Secret Session. Right. Everybody that's pushing it out there. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out to all the lovely
everybody over here, man.
Hello,
Expert
Sunshine.
710 Studios, man. Shout out to all y'all. It's a big movement. We're everywhere. We got to push it together.
And shout out to Andrew for fixing the computer. If you're ready, my friend, get that started to run. Let's try and play that video again.
Jara.
I hear it.
Hey, that's the West Coast thing right there, baby.
We don't got the video for it, but we can hear it.
Hey.
Almost. Usually we're a little bit better prepared
than
this.
It ain't like the West Coast riding in my drop top.
Would you like to taste this, champ?
I'm blunts, man. We're not the super closest friends of all time.
It's a Swisher Sweet from California.
All right. Well, Andrew, you need more time because we can always just jump to the favorite four if that'll help you.
I think we got it now.
I think we got it. Third time's a charm?
Hey,
technology.
Shout out to all those Vancouver strains that we're smoking right now. You know what I'm saying? White Castle, that Def Bubba, you know what I'm saying? The Pink Tom Kush.
Shout out to MMJ.
And you do know that,
right?
You hear me? for supplying us with all the dope. Let's do some business together. Let's get into this marijuana
expert
thing.
Joints,
you know what I'm saying?
Shout out to Parker.
Right, thank you, man.
Extracts. Parker likes
Cody
it. He
Mack.
Picked off somewhere.
He's a real ball pound.
Hit it. Just run it whenever you got it,
Parker,
kid.
Adam.
Fingers crossed, y'all. The video. Ooh. Maybe.
Ooh. ATLA right here, Gip and Daz. You already know. WW Gip and Daz.
When the world stops, when the world stops, when the world stops, Dad, you give, when the world stops. Now when your world stops spinning, if you lose or you're winning, when you realize, tell me what you got.
What you got?
Now when your girl stop tripping, when you're smiling and you're grinning, think it is, but it ain't, but it's not.
But it's
oh,
not.
I get high,
so high,
one day at a time, I let shit pass by. One day at a time,
Be empathetic, be kind, baby, I'm understanding. Assertive, be honest, baby, I'm understanding. Don't fuck around and piss me off or I'm a touch. Hit your block up, hit your hood up with that paintbrush. They having private conversations, baby, keep it lit. Walking through fire with water, baby, got plenty of blessings. Them bullet bars, them avenues, I really touch. Touch the sky and match the gas, oh baby, what a rush. Back in them streets, plenty of faith, I never lose. See, my knowledge is power, baby, got plenty of juice. I got a bird's eye view. Smoking and sipping, look up, it's all thing.
Now when the world stops spinning, if you lose or you're winning, when you realize, tell me what you got.
What you got?
Now when your girl stop tripping, when you're smiling and you're grinning, think it is, but it ain't, but it's not.
But it's
oh,
not.
I get high,
so high,
one day at a time,
one day at a time,
and let shit pass by,
shit pass by,
one day at a time, time.
If you know what you got, then you ain't got much. Take it one day at a time, blessed with that mighty touch. I hit the clutch, burn rubber from second to sixth gear. The road to follow was not far, but so near. My bitch is clear, my Versace shakes can get away. There's so many in and out ways for to get paid. My bitch tripping, money, yo, we the track bitches. She think I'm dipping in that pussy, yeah, I'm in it, won't admit it. Yeah, that nigga dance packing two Dillingers. Willing that big body monster up in the hill and up. Bird's eye view, I'm smoking and sipping. Stop, pause, turn around, start thinking.
Now when the world stops spinning, if you look at me, what you got?
What you
got? Smelling and you're grinning, think it is, but it ain't, but it's not.
But it's
oh,
not.
I get high,
so high.
One day at a time, pass by.
Shit pass by.
One day at a time,
all those that ain't got hope. Without hope, there's no life. Love is love. Death is death. You only grown once, but you a baby twice.
Oh, would you look at that? We made it all the way through. And I'm glad because it was dope too. And you're right, it was snowy. That's what it looked like here like 2 days ago, homie.
Yeah, you know. Directed by Ed Hood, Rich Etsby, my own boy, you know what I'm saying? Mm. So, you know, just having fun, man, with the camera.
That's funny. I didn't know it snowed like that in Long Beach.
It didn't snow like that and like that in Long Beach.
Right? In the LVC, some snow?
Hey, they see some snow, everybody going
there. Man, you know, like I said, I would love to have you cats here all day. I know you got to get the sound check, but before I can let you go, there are four questions that I have to ask everybody who comes on the show, and celebrities are not internationally famous. You're not exempt from them. Andrew, okay. It's time for the favorite four. I got all kinds of cuts for all the different segments. You should see the cooking one and shit. But anyway.
Right.
Question number one.
Yes.
For my friends over here. I ask everybody, and you guys get the same question. So we'll start this way, closest to me and move down the line.
To the man, 1 million.
How and when did you get into weed? When did you first start smoking, or how did that story go? Some homie from around the way, fucking.
No.
Steal something from your sister's drawer.
Right. Let me see. The first time I puffed, and probably when I was 15, and me had allowed young Maxine to be around his bigger cousin, and it was a thing like. And you're like,
okay.
And one thing about me, I feel right in line though. When they pass, and I'm gonna follow what they do.
Hey, lead by example.
It's called hit it twice and pass.
And you do know that, right?
Puff, puff.
And you really didn't understand. Really didn't understand.
We got that segment coming up actually in a minute called Puff Puff Pass Along, some giveaways and shit we're gonna make happen later in the show.
Oh yeah.
And I would be passing y'all joints, but y'all rolling your own joints and blunts over there anyway. So we good. We all.
Oh, yeah.
Where did you come from? Your first where and when did you how when did you get into weed? We've heard the story. But,
all up, but you know, just smoking. You know what I'm saying? It, like Snoop say, we got the word from hydroponic.
Yep.
But we couldn't know how to really say it like that at first, so we said the chronic.
Ooh.
And that's how the chronic word came up.
Man, there's a little bit of history you did not know. I could have saved that for my next
segment. Like I said before, us as a crew, the whole inmates and Dr. Dre, Snoop Dogg, Corrupt, Shit, everybody about that time, we started the world smoking chronic.
You okay.
Know what I'm saying? Smoking weed, it wasn't legal back then. We was going to jail for the shit.
So, and watch the replay and the videos, and I've said it time and time again.
It didn't matter
whether you were like 19 or you were like 14 or you were 25. Dudes who worked in like the auto shop kind of deal or were in garage, you know, mechanic class, some sort of shit, who would go around bike back at the smoke doors or some shit and puff a little bit by the bike racks, to everybody around suddenly fucking smoking the chronic. I credit that with the normalization.
I say bail went up after that time because everybody was going to jail.
Well, you want to talk about bails, man. Saltwater Cowboy Tim McBride moved 30 million pounds back in the 80s and shit. We'll introduce y'all later. He's on the show after in a second.
Damn.
You don't know. One of the biggest potholders of all time. You got nothing on George Jones. Question number one, still to you, Salam. Where did it start? When did that happen?
First time I smoked weed, my brothers kidnapped me and took me to Santa Cruz to go camping with a bunch of girls. And we went camping on the beach overnight, and that was the first time my big brothers pulled out a joint, and I smoked a joint with them.
There you go.
And I got so high, I just stayed in the tent while they was running around the beach like with a bunch of chicks.
It happens to the best of us, man.
I gotta go back to Santa Cruz. Shout out to everybody up to Santa Cruz, too. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Woo. Question number two. Let's go back the opposite way, then. Your preferred method of consumption, joints, blunts, dabs, bongs, what do you reach for?
When I'm at home?
The tools.
I got a bong. I got an Illadelph. I got a big Roars. I like little snaps. Ice, maybe a straight tube.
Yeah,
that's you know what I'm saying?
Daz, your go-to, I see you smoking on a blunt. Is that your fucking morning, noon, and night, or what is that your jam?
You know, I keep a variety pack. It's called the Tools of Life.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So I have dabs and wax and pens, all the free shit.
Yeah, I got that all in my office. It's true. Sean, you've been huffing blunt since you got here, B, and you've been holding those swishers awful close. I'm gonna go on a limb and say that is your preferred method of consumption.
Come on, say it.
Well, you know me, I usually have a plethora of, you know,
options
of different things that I like to do, from the blast to the dab to the blunt to the rolling paper. So, you know, it really is like depends on how I'm
doing. Typically, you're like a little bit, or you're
every day?
I smoke
about a zip a day, man.
There you go.
A blast.
Right?
Nothing less than a half ounce, you hear me?
Mm-hmm. Gentlemen, I'll let you guys decide who wants to answer it next then.
Hold on, wait, who?
What you want?
How much do you consume in a day, typically? Are you like an everyday, all day, couple joints in the morning, something, a little bit?
I'm all till I
kind of pace myself, because I don't want to, you know, man, it's so much every day, you know what I'm saying? And then when you're doing secret sessions every weekend and out of town every other week, and everybody's trying to give you dabs and blunts and all this craziness. You know, I probably do about a half pound a day. No, a half ounce.
Yeah.
I wish I could. I mean,
but if you measure enough.
And I try to cut back.
Or how many blunts? You know, what's your sort of, you got a rough tally?
Yeah, it probably go to like about damn near 50 to 60.
I know
my homeboy, every time we got a show, he rolled 100 blunts.
If you stay at home one day
and don't go nowhere, how many blunts you going to smoke at your house that day if it was raining?
What happened when you don't go nowhere?
20.
You know what? You
20.
Save money.
20.
Right? That's right.
You save money when you stay home.
But how many blunts you smoke when you at home?
Not less, you know.
I do about 10 myself.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. But so when I'm out, half ounce a day or something.
When I'm out,
oh man, it goes
I
up.
Smoke a lot when I'm yeah. out. That's like it. When I'm in town, I mean, like in the house, I might smoke one here, wait a couple hours. You know, it's not like back to back. It's back like when you're feeling, but you know, when I'm out partying and shit, oh, it's
let the me give it to you like this.
Yes, sir.
Morning before lunch, that's 3 blunts down.
Yep.
Lunch till 5 o'clock, that's another 3. 5 o'clock to 10 o'clock at night, that's anywhere from.
Right.
I mean,
and then, the best and then you got bed. One for bed.
And if you got a bitch on.
Oh wow.
Oh hell no.
What if somebody gives you a phone call, stresses you out?
Oh wow.
Add a blunt.
There's a difference between like just smoking on a day by yourself. And I'll take 31-gram king size joints to it and come home with like. 2, maybe, you know what I mean?
Right.
Like for 8 hours, 10 hours on site, like you stay. But I do a judge's kit sometimes. I did 143 samples in 21 hours for High Times.
You know I've what done I mean? That.
So you know how hard
I've done
is.
High oh, Times. Wow. I've done Chalice.
Yep.
60-something strains we had to do in a couple days.
Yep.
Tournament. I
yep.
mean, you know, you got to get the buddy system, man. You got to get some friends over.
Right.
You got to get a little powwow going because you can't do it yourself.
Emerald Cup.
You're
gets
not
a whole,
the judge.
Let Emerald me. Cup gets a whole committee, and it takes like a couple weeks. There's 975 to sample.
Exactly.
Bro. How you gonna do that?
Exactly.
How they gonna
you
do
know,
it?
Like I see some guys judging edibles. How can you judge edibles? You got to sit down. You can't just eat 20 edibles and say, oh, this one's the best. You're just high.
Right?
I assume, do you take a little nip or do you take a dip
right.
when you're doing edibles?
Mm.
Do you take a little bit or do you taste it like that or do you?
Yeah. No, when I'm testing stuff and I've got like 25 edibles to go through, I like, okay, I'm not judging on like potency or overall
you
that sort of
taste.
And I just don't judge any of them. But yeah, I go taste, I go flavor, you know, the packaging, the way it, oiliness, or you know, whatever the fuck it is, the other criteria, but I just don't eat enough of it to get really high because there's no way in 4 or 5 or 6 days you can do 20 edibles, 50 concentrates, 10
what I
10
do, I go downtown the with the bums and stuff in.
Hand them out after.
And I hand them out and I just kick back and say, like, oh yeah. Oh,
see
yeah,
who's
yeah.
falls down first.
Yeah.
And that was the strongest, that's the winner.
Yeah.
And last question then, out of all of the weed that y'all ever smoked from gotta be something out of it that stands out as the most memorable bag that you ever consume, and it's like the best bag ever. And we say if you can't get it again, it's like the one that got away. But Daz, what's the most memorable strain you've ever
the
smoked?
The most memorable strain that I smoked was in Northern California.
Where
Richmond,
at?
Vallejo.
In that Bay Area when he would
it's called Cat Piss.
Oh wow.
I know that.
I can't even recall that. It was just so fumigational.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And it just, it's not there no more. It's gone.
Real
business. And an ounce back then was at least $450.
Right.
Oh, wow.
$450 a zip back then.
I saw one for $485 in Seattle just on Sunday at the Dope Awards.
Cat piss?
Well, not of cat piss, but whatever, $485 wow. ounce.
Cat piss,
I haven't seen cat piss in years. I think that gets some of those ones, like this Purple Skunk #1 that was my most memorable of all time.
Oh, wow.
They were just too smelly to be able to commercially grow anymore without attracting everybody
stash.
In too fucking a mile away.
Strong
or
stash.
Further. Max Sean, most memorable bag ever.
Machine.
Man, let me think here, man. You know, I've had so many, it's really hard for a guy like me to even say, right?
Right, you know what I mean?
You understand,
something
right.
that stand out. Or a session, this one time you smoked a something and it was the most standout moment. Or if you need a moment, maybe Salam got an answer.
I do need a moment, okay. though. I have so Salam. Many, I just can't pinpoint right now. Bear with me, champ.
Funny as it may be, I used to bud tend a little bit back in the day. And they used to get this strain.
Not what they called it at that day, but you know.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
They used to get this strain, and it was a 707 headband.
Yep.
Oh, wow.
You know what I'm saying? And
I
see a lot of people label in headband, but it ain't that no more.
Mm-hmm.
No, it's not.
Detail.
No, it's not. Shouts and they don't label it no home, more. Man. You know what I'm saying?
Right. I used to get a really nice headband here, so I can, and I've heard the legends of the original 707.
Yeah.
Al's nodding his head over there, so.
You do know that.
That one's pretty memorable.
707 is there you go.
This one guy used to come around with this lemon OG that was really, really good too, man. He always used to have a little bit of it. Like, you'd only get a cube here or something. It'd give you like a fucking ounce, maybe. And that was really, really good too. I forgot where the fuck
you
that
You see if
came.
Al's got some of the lemon Larry. Max Sean, you got,
okay,
you got to stand. Oh, yeah, there, big dog?
Once upon a time in the city of San Francisco, Fillmore was the district, right?
That's right.
And there was some weed that was coming from Canada.
There you go.
And we was calling it Nade. right? And we was getting pounds of the shit, but it was coming compressed in a little square bitty brick. Remember that?
Uh-huh.
This is around 1997, 98.
That was called Louis Vuitton up here.
Hey, boy.
Louis Vuitton up here, Al says.
Man, I had a hell of a well of a time when that was coming through there. And we had about maybe 4 or 5 years on that nade, man. And it was coming from here. And I just remember a lot of good times. Can't remember a specific time.
But that VC Bud, man, does it every time.
Well,
speaking of Bud, I figured we might somebody might say it was that DPG Buds.
Oh, yeah. Oh wow.
Ooh.
The new
but, you know.
Have you tried that yet?
Well, there you go. There's the website right there.
I mean, you know what I'm saying? We got the finest Buds. Shout out to Ming, Jake, Cam, and all the staff there at Seattle Private Reserve. You know what I'm saying? And they got the best clean weed. You know what I'm saying? They are perfectionists at telling.
I'll tell you right now, people that go out to Seattle, because you know Seattle's 21 and up.
And I was just there and you can't open any of the packages,
right.
So you don't know what you fucking
right.
with. Yep.
You know, here, if you go to a dispensary, they'll open the jar for you, they'll let you smell stuff, even touch it sometimes. You know what I'm saying? Over there, everything's pre-packaged. So you gotta know your brands. So that Seattle Private, go check it out. They got the G-Cut. They got the
Lavender.
They got the Illegal.
Legalized
OG. Oh man, all the
Hollywood.
And I'll tell you some of the difference, and you probably know this too. You ever smoke some, and then you smoke some other weed, and you're like, man, it's real clean.
Mm-hmm.
Like they flushed it real good.
Yep.
They just got everything
that
out of
white
it.
White ash gang shit. Real, I like that black ash.
Real clean when you hit it. Yeah, yes. That real white ash.
Like weed is supposed to be. Finished
yes.
weed.
Right.
Yeah, yeah, that. Yeah.
That's what it's going on over there with that Seattle DPG Buds.
Oh.
Go check that out.
And I wish I would have got some there on Sunday, but I will look for it the next time I'm down there. DPG Buds available in the Seattle area, man.
And
check out the website.
All of Washington. From Spokane all the way down to Long
Tacoma.
Beach, Washington.
DPGBuds.com.
Yeah.
I bet you if you looked in Weed Maps too, you might even find some info where you can find it too.
Yes. Yes, sir. You know what I'm saying? It's just strictly in the state of Washington.
We're going to see it in Canada
I'm
one day, though, maybe?
I'm down there, so I have no competition.
Canada, maybe one day?
Hey,
maybe?
That's what I'm trying to do right now. So let's get it together. We're right here with all the people who could really make this happen.
You kind of are.
You know what I mean?
You ain't gonna lie, you kinda are.
This is the room of opportunity, guys!
Let's just go and get the TRPs together.
Right, so let's get the lawyers to fucking make sure they happen, get them TRPs in place.
You better know it.
Shout outs to Canadian Customs.
Or give me a wheelchair.
Hey, Drake, Justin, write us a letter. Write us a letter, dog, we need a letter.
He says, give me a wheelchair.
Give me a wheelchair.
I just need Drake or Justin to write me a letter, we good.
Tell him, Parker.
It's already happening, huh, baby?
Gentlemen, if I may.
Come here,
Parker. We're at the end of the segment. Any plugs, shouts outs, things we missed?
Man, y'all just keep checking out for Daz Dillinger at Daz Dillinger all across the board. You know what I'm saying? Here and there, Daz and Mataz coming, 32 songs. Holla at me right here. 7.
Max Sean.
Check out Max Sean 100.
You know, that's that's my freeway.
All digital outlets.
You know, the 710 freeway.
Everything. The next record, So Fly, So Wet. And follow Max Shine 100 around the world, around the globe. And you do know that. That's MACSHAWN 100. And you do know that, okay?
Hey, man, I just want to say tune in to motherfucking Expert Joints 420. You know what I'm saying? That's what's up. Slam Rec. You know where to find us. We
710
everywhere.
710 Studio.
Oh, I love it, man. I appreciate you guys being
in
here.
The
yes.
building.
Follow all the gods, man. We appreciate you guys doing it. I was going to play a commercial break, but I figure we got that bang bang.
Yeah, let's go bang bang right here. Produced by Daz Dilly, you already know. Featuring Be Legit, Big Gip.
And you know what?
Daz and Mataz, new album, 32 songs, all the back.
And fingers crossed it plays the whole time this time on the first time.
Oh,
Andrew?
Yeah, for sure. Let's do it.
We good?
Please believe it.
Okay. For life, double cup, like I'm in the A. I'm so sick with it, like I'm in the Bay.
Yeah, I'm this way, that away, any given Saturday. Gas up in the ashtray next to where the ladder lay. Smoke about a half a day, you know I be with it. Bag in Fort Bragg, I send a homie to get it. Every morning I hit it, hold and never pass it. Deuce is a classic, Kush be fantastic. Glocks in the plastic, we cashed them out.
Spray the whole block just to hash them out. Then we smash them out. Be yelling that gang gang. 40 get the poppin', barely missing your membrane. Niggas is insane, youth don't listen. Pistol in a pill, send them off on a mission. Need to play your position, stay in your lane. Sharpen your game, a nigga bang, bang.
I just be going hard, it's a daily thing. We got different grinds, but we gang the same. So if I called you a bitch, if I called you lame, let's get it crackin', nigga bang, bang. Double cup, like I'm in the act. I'm so sick with it, like I'm in the back. Come to Cap, welcome to LA. We got crazy bitches and they do not play. Double cup, like I'm in the act. I'm so sick with it, like I'm in the bay. Come to Cap, welcome to LA. We got crazy bitches and they do not play.
My time these days spent in a couple cities. A lot of rest with body armor, need some life insurance. Politics with politicians talking human ethics. Knocking noodles out your medulla, so fine sway. Souffle, broad day up on Broadway. E-way, maroon coupe with the moon roof. Grapefruits all way, long hallway. Catching flights and taking numbers, running ball plays. Never ask it, call my money cachet. Bang, bang, wipe his nose, boy, touche. Fulton County, East Point, real state of Georgia. When niggas die by the kilo, kill you by the quarter. When niggas touch you by them pills, kill you by the dog food. Murder by that money, kill you by the meals. Ain't too much I can tell you. I'm from the South where niggas mask up in the dark and come tell you.
I just be going hard, it's a daily thing. We got different grinds, but we gang the same. So if I called you a bitch, if I called you lame, let's get it cracking, nigga, bang, bang. Double cup, like I'm in the act. I'm so sick with it, like I'm in the bay. Come to Cap, welcome to LA. We got crazy bitches, and they do not play. Double cup, like I'm in the act. I'm so sick with it, like I'm in the bay. Come to Cali, welcome to LA. We got crazy bitches, and they do not play. How you feel it coming? Now I'm in my zone. All you hate niggas, leave me the fuck alone. I'm just doing what y'all really wanna do. Fly bitches, fly cars, niggas count loot. All up in my business, yeah, stay up out of mind. If it don't benefit me, then I ain't got the time. Try to slow down my grind, please stay back in line. If I ain't call your name, get the fuck back in line. Before I hit the stage, yeah, I need all mine. Go magic on the chick, nigga, call it showtime. Ballin' on you niggas, sending y'all to the line. I push it to the limit, don't fuck with mine. West Coast MVP, the DAZ. Iconic, legendary, reppin' DPG. Triple OG, y'all can't take my stripes. For LAFE, I do this shit for life. I just be going hard, it's a daily thing. We got different grinds, but we ain't the same. So if I called you a bitch, if I called you lame, let's get it crackin', nigga, bang, bang. Double cup, like I'm in the act. I'm so sick with it, like I'm in the bay. Come to Cap, welcome to LA. We got crazy bitches, and they do not play. Double cup, like I'm in the act. I'm so sick with it, like I'm in the bay. Come to Cali, welcome to LA. We got crazy bitches, and they do not play.
Hey, what's up? I am back with my YouTube video for sure. It seems like the Facebook video was interrupted. Not sure if it's because of the song that was playing or whether the system crashed for a second, but Andrew's working on refreshing that. Getting probably mixed signals. Some says it's working, some says it's not. But at least we're here on YouTube and we appreciate it. Yeah, I'm not seeing it, but it should come back. Anyway, nevertheless, Andrew's working hard to make the show happen. And also working hard to make the show happen is the folks at Grassroots Medicinal, Lone Tree Concentrates, Top Leaf, as well as Thompson Caribou, Flight, and Green Society. All these folks will pitch in, so please go support them at grassrootsmedicinal.ca, lonetreeconcentrates.ca, topleaf.ca, thompsoncaribou.com, flight.life, greensociety.ca, all today.
kind of make it all happen. And lots of people supporting season 3 of Expert Joints, and I appreciate it. Also, lots of sponsors and artists supporting tonight's show, The Kickdown. Going down tonight at Fortune Sound Club, 147 East Pender, with my first guests, Daz Dillinger, Max Sean, Salam Rek. And also, as mentioned on the bill as well, is my man Creed Taylor. Because you got to say it with the excitement. You know, he's known as the Davin Rapper. And well, it is about that time. And you did know that Turf Fire is also helping us bring together the Kickdown event as well, too, if you look at the very small logo at the bottom of the poster. And well, they make dabs. So I figured what a perfect opportunity to get three of us stoned at once as we roll into dab time. Welcome back, Facebook. Sorry about that. Don't know what happened. You've been not the pleasantest thing to deal with for all the shows as of late. So, I don't know. Sorry. If you missed any of it, hopefully it'll catch back up somewhere in the replay. Otherwise, you'll just have to watch it on YouTube or expertjoints.com later. It be what it be. But that was cool as shit. And also cool as shit, that's my man, Creed Taylor, and the products from Turf Fire, which is contradictory because they're fire products, but they're cool. You know what I mean? It's good, right? It's fire, but it's tough to fit the segues all in, but we try. From Turp Fires, my man Ryan, welcome to the show. Good to have you here, dude. Don't normally see you on the show yet or on the Pod TVs a lot, at least I haven't had you here yet, but.
Busy guy, always doing something.
Right, I know how it goes. Creed Taylor, of course, old face, we've had you here, man. Good to see you.
Good to be here, man.
From the People Northwest, I guess, at this point.
Hell yeah.
Performing tonight, clarify, is it you or is the whole crew?
It'll be the majority. As you know, T. Crispel, she's out in
on the east side holding it down.
She's doing her thing out there, shout out T. Crispel, she's right. Killing it.
Played a video a couple weeks ago, Murder, Girls Murder.
Let It Slide, yeah, produced by the homie Moxa too. Moxa and I have a couple songs together. He's a monster on the production for sure. But no, People Northwest is still in full effect. We got so many songs ready to drop. We're just waiting and strategizing, you know.
I love it, man. Yeah. I got some dabs over here waiting to get dabbed.
That's what's up.
The tonight you're opening for the band, of course, and I heard you got some tickets to give away to that.
Yes, sir. So on Kush Queen's show the other week, we did a little giveaway, and we promised to...
Give some of that away.
Yeah, for sure. No, I promised to provide a couple grams of live resin from Nectar Extracts here, as well as a brand new unreleased HTFSE live resin pen.
Wow.
And there was people entering on Instagram, and I got the list here, and I got a random number generator in my pocket, and we could do this shit right now.
Well, I think we do a dab first. Keep the suspense rigid for a second. We're going to smoke some of that Turf Fire for a second. I know you brought some of that. I don't mean to cross over or whatever, but you know, obviously they're supporting the event. I got the little mountain of it built out here. We got lots of it, and you like fire.
They got the fire, man. There's right? No doubt.
And that Nectar, nice little bonus, man. I'll try some of that later. We'll get some of that in the dab there. Shout out to dab Nectar desk later on. But for those unfamiliar with Turf Fire, of course, what kind of products do you guys make?
Pretty much everything necessary. There's not a lot, not as much right now in the topicals because it's just been really busy, but lots of HTFSE, more of the waxes and wax and stuff. I know it sounds funny, but you know.
You were doing like a lot of the live resins.
A lot of live resins, stuff. Though. It's really, yeah. It's what everybody's been kind of asking. Yeah, for quite a while I've been making live resins, and people seem to like it a lot. So.
And now they're getting saucier and saucier, more and more complicated all the time.
Harder to contain.
Well, here, but more fun to smoke.
This one's easy. That one's easy right there. It's all contained in one. so you brought me some of what's going to be in the swag bags tonight.
Yeah.
What is it?
Lost Coast OG Live Resin, HTFSE, HCFSE, full spectrum extract.
Can you explain or break down the acronyms? The alphabet there, because the XYZ, PD, LMNOQ,
it's high terpene, full spectrum extract, or high cannabinoid, full spectrum extract.
Got it.
So basically, full spectrum extract is really what it is. You can keep them separated, you can put them back together, you can play with it any way you want.
It's getting that refined now, that nerdy.
One has a really high terpene content, low cannabinoid content. The other one is high cannabinoid, low terpene. So you could go for a super spacey high and drop some straight THCA crystals, or you can go for a really flavorful, aromatic, saucy dab of mostly terps. It allows you to be a little more diverse with your dab selection, and that's what the connoisseurs are looking for these days.
You know what I do kind of like? I like sometimes doing the live shows and fucking with people, because, you know, I'm using the Dablarium, and if you guys have seen it on Instagram, I know you've tuned in for the odd live stream here and there. You know, I got like 140-50 flavors at the house. It's stupid, right? It's ridiculous. But it's kind of neat to sometimes, on the show, when you put together, see if I can get 7 or 8 different things on the head of a dab tool and blast them all at once. And you know what I mean?
That'd be pretty challenging. It's quite drippy.
It is. This stuff moves around. So I am looking forward to trying it, but this is dab time, and I can't be the only one. So we got that Corey Glass piece on top of the sublimator over there. You are the dabbing rapper. You brought the fire here. I don't know what you're going to dab over there, Ryan, but... I see you got some other envelopes.
I have a few other flavors.
Yeah, what else you got?
I gotta save these ones for the giveaway.
So yeah, so there you go.
I got some Big Bowl, which is one that we do in-house, both the flowers and the little bit of Mount Rainier Pink Kush mix.
My man.
More of that Lost Coast, just a much larger jar of it.
Mm-hmm.
Super Silver Sage, Gorilla Glue.
Creep Taylor, what are you thinking, man?
Let me try that Silver Sage there that you just wrapped in a nice
I like it. So is that like a in-house thing? Do you guys do your own flower?
I do as much flower as I can. I mean,
source some of the other best fire that you can find. Yeah, I get you.
But I mean, I threw a little bit there for you to give a whirl too there.
Yeah, I appreciate it, man. I'm looking forward to trying it. Waiting for you motherfuckers to catch up. No.
All right, are we going in at the same time?
Yeah, man, well, I put a little bit under the dab cam already. We saw that. We've obviously been smoking more of these throughout the show. But yeah, for now, it's time, y'all. So get your dabs ready. It's dab time. We need like a little song that plays here or something, a little jingle. There's a clutch on the bottom. There's a clutch button on the bottom.
I see that. I'm not used to these sublimator things.
Yeah, this is the sublimator 3.0 as well, too, so it's got the fancy dancy. Oh, you ain't kidding. Right? Right?
All right.
Oh. The saltwater cowboys. Impressed. Wow. Man. That is hitting. particular method to... to make your dabs, no secrets given away, but
just super cold temperatures. Try and get absolutely no chlorophyll. Keep it as cold as humanly possible.
When you're processing live material, it's really important to get cryo temperatures. It allows your solvent to be more effective, and it doesn't strip nearly as many plant facts, waxes, chlorophyll, lipids. It allows for a much easier de-wax with a single solvent as opposed to using a second stage solvent. So this is for people who, the dab nerds that care about this stuff.
Ask an expert. The artist formerly known as the dab and rapper after all.
Hey, I've been doing this since way before people were calling them dabs, you know.
Right.
I've been around.
Well, and you've also talked about, you've been represented some other companies.
For sure, man, for sure. Definitely, too, definitely.
So, no stranger to the game.
Yeah, so, I'm a bit of a consultant, you could say.
If you will. Well,
exactly.
That's cool, man. Let me ask you both sort of the same question, but in a different way.
What's up?
If you're trying to get some of these Terpfire products to this dab time and you want to dab them, we know you can follow Terpfire as Terpfire Extractions on Instagram, but... how do they get some products for themselves?
Lots of times, just go to your local dispensaries. If they don't have it, ask for it. It can definitely make its way there very quickly.
Cool. do you need a doctor's prescription or just be 19 and ID or?
Generally, everything. Yeah, we want to see either prescription. We like to try and keep it mostly medicinal. I mean, there's a few rec shops we carry as well, like the Cannabis Cultures and whoever else. But
special ones, I guess, here and there.
A few of them we have, kind of got in there earlier or whatever. So
I love it.
But yeah, I mean,
Good products, man.
Get it out to the world is the way it goes.
known for it. I like the new jars over the green packages were cool before, but
you know, these are nice. This stuff won't even work in a package.
Yeah, of course you can't.
Just
do
lots
that
of mess. We tried it.
Too messy.
Times.
Too messy.
Oh yeah.
And then Creed Taylor.
What's up?
Kind of what's coming next for you, and how do people kind of keep up? I know we got the Creed Taylor on the social media, but what's next for you and the rest of the peoples from the Northwest and kind of East?
Well, this show tonight, this will be the last show of a long, relatively productive year for us. This was kind of our first year hitting full stride. We played a lot of shows. We did a little bit of touring. It was fairly successful. So closer to the end of the year, we really concentrated on songwriting and recording, and we got a lot of material in the bank right now, and we're just, like I said, waiting to release, and I don't know, lots of new stuff. I'm really proud of this music. I feel like it's some of the best music I've ever been a part of, written. Shouts out to Marlo, who once again produces every single thing that I rap on, basically. I don't know, he's killing it. We're just having fun, man. We're just doing our thing.
More to come, next things to release soon. When do we kind of, can you give us a sneak peek of when the next project is or what we should be kind of watching for?
Yeah, straight up, we got a track called Three the Hard Way. This is kind of one of our first singles we're going to drop after kind of going on a month-to-month-to-month-to-month spree of dropping singles. Right. So, Three the Hard Way. We'll be previewing that tonight, new song at the Daz show. So
nice.
If anyone wants to come through, we'll be dropping quite a few new tracks as well. I just released a single, Lemongrass and Spinach, if you haven't seen
right.
that. You can check that out,
right.
too.
We'll get that on. Are you back to see the other video when it comes? We'll hold it down. We've got more time to catch up with you or some of the rest of your people.
For sure. They'd love to come through.
From Turnfire. You got some new recipes or some new crazy concoctions you're working on. I mean, what's next from the science labs, man? What are we going to see coming from you?
Really working a little more in the garden, just trying to get a bunch of different flavors out there. The strawberry sour diesel is one I'm kind of playing with, really like. And going back to starting material, because I think that's going to be really the thing at the end of the day, is the better the starting material, the better your product will be.
Sure, 100%.
Fire in.
Fire out.
Always.
That's the mantra.
I love it, man.
Credit to the grower, man. That's like honestly one of the most important things for sure. If it's grown right, it'll.
You can only polish a turd so much, you know what I mean?
We say that often.
And more importantly, when you're making fucking extracts with it, you concentrate the turd into the most biggest, craziest, all the worst parts of it that you can possibly get.
Okay.
So, you know, there's that.
It smells like a turd and tastes like a turd, and you extract the essence of it, it's going to be the essence of a turd.
Right?
You know?
This is going to be quite turd.
That's how it goes, man. I love it. Well, no turds around here, just turd fire, man. I love it.
Straight
and
up.
And Creed Taylor, right? Yeah. Man, all right, well, I think we've made him wait long enough. Creed Taylor, give them...
All right.
To the random number generator.
Let's do this.
We'll see who's the person...
Pull it up.
Now, all these people, you got to get to the show and, like... 3, maybe 4 hours from now.
Yeah, I will DM the winner. It's a short list, I'll be honest. Not that many people entered, so your odds are really, really good.
I think you figure that these are the right people from around the way. They're all Canadian, is sort of local.
Yeah, they seem to be. So I got a list. It's short. It's a very short list. So if you're on there, it's really good odds. I'm going to press this right now.
A 9 or whatever the fuck it is.
All right, random number generator says number 3. That's J_Chan with 4 N's. So, J Chan, Jesse Chan. I think I know that guy too. He's a friend and a follower of mine. So thanks for your support. Thanks for entering the giveaway. And you get 2 grams of this fire. I believe this is chemo live resin from Nectar Extracts. You get 2 tickets to the show tonight. So you and a homie, or you and your girl, whatever, you know. And you also get this pen from Nectar Extracts as well, which is straight HTFSE, which is the high terpene fraction with a little bit of cannabinoids in there as well. But tastes fire and gets you high.
Is there any possibility my man Ryan will be down to throw in
I think we definitely would have to.
And here, why not? Throw in a couple of fucking from Turf Fire, just because why not?
Fucking Jay Chan, you just came up on 2 more jars here of live resin. So shout out to the homie Turp Fire right here. Thanks for hooking it up. Right. Shout out to Craig. Thanks for letting us use this. Shout out to Kush Queen too. She had me on her show earlier this week, and that's where we did this giveaway. So shout out to Al Classes in Session, aka the Cannabee beast, you know.
Right.
Always doing his thing.
Speaking of can of beast, what is this little nug that I just about to put here from out from under the jar that's now gone in the bud cam just before I let you go, man? Who dropped this loveliness on my desk? What is this? It's come from one of you guys?
Strawberry sour diesel.
Oh, man. Looks good to me, man. Oh, so good. I love it, I love it, I love it. Well, I'm going to roll that up as we get to part out of here. I appreciate you guys coming through. I really do, man, hanging out. Follow Creed Taylor and the People Northwest on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, all those sort of places.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, we'll see you at the Fortune Sound Club for the kickdown tonight.
Hell yeah.
My man Ryan over here, Turp Fire Extractions on Instagram and at finer cannabis retailers everywhere. Medicinal places. At least reasonable. Decent medical shops around the way, and if you're in the know, you can find it. If you're not, direct message them. They'll tell you where to get a hold of it around you.
We'll find it.
Right? We'll make sure you get that Turp Fire if you want it, and I suggest that you do. It comes highly recommended.
Mm-hmm.
That said, I know you got to get out to that sound check as well, too.
That's
going to start out, and I know you're going to the event. You're welcome to hang with the rest of the show, or you're going to have to make way because I got somebody else who came through, and I think he just flew in here. I'm sure his arms are real tired. It's time for one of Tim's Tales. Oh, boy. It's all right. And it is 2 weeks later, and this is the part where I Skype in with Tim McBride, but if you've been following this big, crazy motherfucker, you have seen he has been making his way here to spend at least most of the holidays with various parts of us. I think he's got to go back at some point. We don't get to keep him forever, but we get to keep him for a while anyway. And instead of doing it via Skype, we're going to do this episode live in person because, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Studio 710, the one and only Tim McBride.
Hello. Hello,
everybody. What's going on, big man?
Literally just got here, man.
Bro, and I think didn't you have to buy pants to even come up here?
Yeah, I had to buy warm clothes to get my ass here this time, too.
I've never seen you not wearing shorts, bro. It's weird.
I was wearing them the day before I left, which was yesterday, about 3 a.m.
Yeah, no, I saw that, which was about 2 hours before I went to bed.
It's brutal. But hey, you know, it's all worth it, dude. Up here, and, you know, my good friend Steve, the Butter King, he's sponsoring me up here this time for over the holidays, and I want to give a shout out
to Butter King. Shout out to 2137 Commercial Drive, Butter Kings. Yeah. Go down and check down there. So tell Cushy that Craig X sent you. And she'll be like, hi. And she'll be all nice to you. She'll do that anyway. But if you do that and
she's
say that, she'll throw
anyways,
it around. She'll,
no matter what.
She'll like, I don't know, she'll probably just say, fuck that guy. No. She'll be happy to see you. Tell her Tim sent you. And then she'll be really, really happy. Big Dog, you like my Christmas decorations?
This is Christmassy, man.
This
is the first time. I mean, I was here when it was like naked.
I was just gonna say, you saw it when it was still a construction site, man. It was shit on the floor and holes in the walls.
Exactly.
What do you think, man?
It's sweet.
Thank you, brother.
You know, it's a whole different feel when you sit here rather than watch it, from where everybody else is sitting, man. But it's all good, man. It's cool.
Chilling like a villain knows it, and the crowd goes wild. Yes, from the chat room, from Southwest Florida, all the way to Vancouver here, in Studio 710, the one and only Timmy McBride.
You know, a lot of these people in the chat have jumped over on Instagram at me too, and that's which is very cool.
Yeah, man. Shouts to all
the followers. It's always nice to see a familiar name stroll past on the screen, but unfortunately, where I'm sitting, you can't see that shit.
Right. Well, we can't see it here right now. I can sort of see it on the chat room here. And Peter S. says, always great to see a hero. Two Joint says, Tim's awesome. And 420 Wild Dragon just says, Rocket Kush Queen, because why not?
Kush Queen, yeah, she's just,
what's up, Kush?
Yeah, she's sweet.
We'll see you soon, sweetheart. We'll run into you somewhere in the next few days, absolutely.
I'm going to be hanging out for a while.
Right, so you're here for a minute. Maybe for this week and for next week's episode, even though it wouldn't be technically one of your shows after what you come through.
Sure, I'll hang out and,
Got a little New Year's
do
party.
A couple dabs and smoke some of your expert freak and joints.
I got a little bit of that for you. So let's talk about how was the flight. Travel was fine.
Not bad. I always get along with the people I sit with,
Yeah, you're not that hard to get along with.
Yeah, no, we always have a cool chat and it makes the time go by really, really cool. Like the last time I come up, Right. I think I told you, I sat next to this Korean dude.
Yep.
And his little daughter. He didn't speak a lick of English, and I, of course, don't speak any friggin' Korean. Yeah. But we had the greatest conversation, man. I mean, it was the coolest thing, coolest conversation I think I've ever had in my life.
So
we were, like, drawing pictures and shit of one another and stuff. You know, it turns out that's how they write anyways. They make pictures and shit.
So how did... turned out cool. Anybody sit in mind really cool this time?
Yeah, some little old lady. She sat next to me. And then, you know, as she got comfortable talking with me, you know, she starts dropping the F-bomb back at me and shit, too, you know. She's like 80-some shit, you know.
Nice.
And nice. Going off about her husband and how he was diagnosed some kind of paranoid schizophrenia or some fucking shit. And they started talking about CBD and talking about, you know, so we had a cool conversation. Of course, one thing led to another, and, you know, my story got brought up, you know, that kind of thing. So that kills a lot of time, obviously. But very cool. You know, and she reminded me just last week. I'm walking through the grocery store, and this little old lady, dude, she's no bigger than the handlebar on the fucking cart in the grocery store, and she walks over and pulls me by my beard just like that. She goes, "I talked to you like 2 weeks ago, and I looked at you and I thought, you're either a cop or some kind of rock star." And I said, "No, ma'am, I'm an author," and kind of left it at that, and she walked away. So here I am, like a month later, she spots me, pulls me out of the crowd, she pulls my beard by the beard in the supermarket like this, and she goes, "You know what? I read your book." She said, "I read it front to back." She said, "I'm a reader," and she said, "I really liked the story, I really loved it." She said, "But one thing that really kind of, you know, irritated me a little bit," she says, "you have no remorse whatsoever for all of that you did." I said, "No, ma'am, not one bit, not whatsoever." She goes, "Oh, that's very interesting." She's coming from the old crowd, you know. She's 81 freaking years old, but she dug the shit out of the story. I thought that was cool. So it doesn't make any difference, you know, how old they are.
Right.
You know, they come out of the woods at me, man. You know, I mean, they open their closet to me, if you will.
Right.
It is easy for them that way.
It's easy for people to fucking like it. I mean, you're a likable guy, and it's a hell of a story. And here's a lighter. Can you talk it out?
Cool.
Not surprised. and not surprised you talked that old lady's ear off, I tell you that much. Because, again, once you get telling that story, it turns into about a five-hour explanation, which is a great amount of time.
Well, that's how it works, man. It's not, I mean, just you can't tell one piece of it.
Well, you told one piece of it to
Vice
Magazine.
But I've been doing
that
for the last 2 years.
Yeah, you have since I found you and put you on fucking TV. No, you're already telling people around that, man. You were doing interviews and stories before I found you, but at least I found you before a lot of other people found you. And then Vice Magazine has found you recently, and the video that we played, that 5 million.
Well, it'll go over 6 million probably this evening. 6 million views, which is kind of cool.
That's neat, man, right?
And I'm getting a lot of chatter, a lot of stuff, you know, and commitments are being made, you know, finally, things like that. my network commitment there in the States has finally come through.
Wow. Well, that's something we talk about off air?
Yeah, we'll go into depth like that, but, you know, that's as much as I'll talk about for right now.
That's cool. We're always glad to see that happen for you, man. You know, I've been a big supporter of yours, and a big supporter. I'm just happy to see the success, and I love to see when other people hear the story, see the story, and they look at me, and I get to go there, so I'm like, yeah, I know.
Hey,
I know.
When you take, you know, you got this thing here.
Right.
You know, you only gotten, you know, maybe this much of something which is, you know, this big. So there's a lot more backstory to all of this.
And we talk about a lot of that during the show and during the during these episodes all the time. And of course, you know, you share some of that stuff through Instagrams and Facebooks and some of the video, you know, just little bits and snippets of pieces and stuff. But it's an incredible story, and you always tell so many tales. And I was thinking what I thought might be you guys, what's up, man? You guys good? Yeah.
Cool. Come in the house.
Yeah, you guys hanging? Yeah, we're still on. You trying to come in?
Come on, man. Have a seat.
How
are you?
Oh, man. Nice, are you trying to hang for a minute, or are you
dead? Yeah, sure, why not, man? I'll cut
a
rug.
Let's get him a mic back then.
Should I cut a rug? All right, something to take some while, man.
There's Al hanging in the background. Hey, what's up, Big Al?
Shit, why not?
Al, does he need to go pretty quick?
Give me a blast. Why not?
Does he need to go pretty quick? Are you guys in a rush? Or okay. Well, shit.
We're just chilling,
gonna hang for a minute. It looks like
just chilling
us again. And Andrew,
it's a pleasure to sit in, man. You know.
Cool.
Shit, why not?
I didn't give you enough stuff to do today. 20%. 20% for Andrew over there.
20%.
Right. Yeah. All right. So yes,
my man Andrew.
What a musical legends, as you know, you saw on the show, man.
Yes.
And smuggling legends that you guys better know if you don't know by now.
The best.
But one of the things I was thinking of.
Nice
was,
to meet you, man.
I don't want to make light of a situation, but Daz and Salam didn't have the best ish. Greeting or welcome or first entry into Canada, customs was a little bit longer for them than it was for probably some other people who crossing through. And so kind of got me thinking of tales to be able to tell. And I know you've got some custom agents, friends and some shit like that, but I thought that maybe one of your tales, and there's a chance you could tell us something about the story with me, your interactions with trying to cross customs or good or bad experience, because you did some international voyages, you went to some Columbia shits. Yeah. Did you have ever have some harrowing in and out of some countries or
yeah,
some
you
shit
know what?
Like
I always went back door, man. They never knew I was there. I didn't go, we didn't land at any international airport or any shit like this. This was runway cut in the jungle. And very well maintained. Maintained well enough to land a small Learjet in, a business jet. Something like that, you know.
Get around.
What's customs? Right. Right. Who are they?
Yeah, who
these are,
they?
Are these assholes running around trying to catch my ass for, you know, 10 years, and or for actually for 40 years they tried catching us and couldn't, you know, get a handle on it. So, I mean, these are the fucking guys we're talking about. Right. But when I did my shit, you know, if I fly to Colombia, you know, to Colombia to the jungles outside of Cartagena, between Cartagena and Santa Marta, I'm landing on a jet on a strip, man, and nobody knows we're there.
That was the best way to get
That's
around
the best
it
way to
avoid.
Get around there.
Just don't deal with them in the first place. A little tougher in this day and age. The
you
guys
so
now
in this
world we live in and stuff. But
you know, they kind of got smart about things. You know, particularly after they, you know, they got by way of how it all worked from me. You know, that was my saving grace, and I couldn't cooperate because. To cooperate would have meant, you know, just shoot me in the fucking head and, you know, and shoot everybody that ever knew me and shit like that. Even though the business that we did it and we grew up as kids doing it, wasn't violent in any way, shape, or form. But if you go throw these guys under the bus, they're going to get violent and this is who the fuck they are, man.
You know what I mean?
Right.
You back anything into a corner and it's going to push back.
Well, you know up into that, you know, it's all good. You know, and then you got these customs guys running around out there, and we talked about a couple of these guys, Ron and Ron.
Mm-hmm.
They were there before my buddy John got there to become their supervisor. Right. Ron, I'll call him Ron 1 and 2. Ron 1 comes from CIA, and the other one comes from Secret Service to run boat interdiction. These guys don't know dick about running boats.
Wow.
And we're running them aground, man. We're running them out, you know, in the backwoods. We run them into dead ends and shit and leave them.
Yeah, you tell us a story about where you were running offshore and you kind of basically high setting them on a sandbar and then drove around and we were like,
they can't drive.
John was on that boat. You know, he's bragging to me one day about, they call it Blue Thunder. And it was, you know, it was a bad, I'm not, give it, it was a badass boat.
Right.
But what they didn't stop to think, take this thought process one step further is, you know, they're using confiscated vessels from buddies of mine. We built these boats. And they're using them as interdiction vessels against us because they can't build these boats.
Wow.
But they're not taking the thought process to back one step further and thinking, well, I built that boat, so I'm just going to build one more badass than that one. So I had 30 mile an hour on that boat. I could leave
you knew what it could do.
I knew what it could do. So when I hear it run, and you could hear this bitch 12 miles away at night on the water. Boom, 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 boom. And here they come, you know.
Real runner.
So we got about 30 minutes before it gets here. Clean your shit up, man. So I take off up north with my buddy just to let him see us because I know he's not catching my ass.
Right.
And I turn around and I got, like I said, I got 30 miles an hour on my boat. So right. I'm pacing him. I'm keeping just ahead of him just enough. And my buddy that was with me, Todd, we had gone and checked the backwaters out the night before. And
you ready?
You got to go?
We found out where
Sound check. All right, well.
Say, champ, nice meeting you. We're going to get together.
But anyways,
tonight,
we wound up running that bitch aground.
Come on, as you should. You hear me? Hey, much love, Craig Gex.
Appreciate
you guys.
Man.
Love you, Canada. Yeah. You hear me? Oh, wow.
Leave that mic with you.
I can't
talk about a mic drop.
Good, okay. Van City, much love, baby. I'll be back again. Who loves you, baby?
We love you, Max Sean, at this point, man. That was
my man.
Awesome.
See you, brother.
Andrew, going to take that mic back from you. Yes, and then the story was...
Yeah,
you
the story was
coming.
We brought him back south and just purposely ran him aground because we knew where the deep water was and he didn't.
Right.
I cut back, and he thought he could cut me off, and I pulled him in the shallow waters, and next thing you know, they're up on their side like this, walking around in ankle-deep water. Man, and me and Jimmy go floating past him like this with a bandana on, smoking a fat one like this, waving at him.
That's what they call home field advantage.
That's right.
Yeah, you know I mean?
Home court advantage. But like I said, these are, I mean, they, you know, I'll give them their, you know, their due. I mean, they tried. You know, I'll give them that. But, you know, I always ask these guys, you know, where the hell were you guys? You know, I mean, you talk about all this badass shit you had. And, you know, you had boats you were using. They had one. It was it looked like a charter kind of vessel, something you would see kind of like a Hatteras or something like that, you know. Right. But it had blacked out windows. And we all knew, I mean, you take one look at it, you know what kind of boat this thing is. It's got 45 fucking antennas on it.
Right.
So they sit offshore about 8-10 miles, and they surveil and shit.
Sure.
And it's like, you know.
The really big binoculars.
You might as well put a big neon sign on your ass.
Yeah, right. Right? Just fucking pinging away
out
there.
Just ridiculous shit like that, you know. I mean, they were going through the motions pretty much. So, I mean, they were helping us more than they were hindering us.
Well, and as your boy John has said to you as well too, I mean, I guess sort of he at least appreciated the fact that there was no guns, there was no concerns in that sort of way, there was no fearing for the life after all he'd been through at that point. It's just trying to catch you motherfuckers was incredibly difficult.
That was the big thing right there. Yeah, right. It was more, and he's today, to this day, they call it the cat and mouse game that we played.
Yeah. You know, well, it really was.
I mean, these guys had fun doing this shit every bit as much as we did, you know, but only we were on opposite
ends. They were getting paid to go fucking play G.I. Joe, man.
That's right. And, you know, and it's sorry to see, you know, what's happening in this day and age. That's cool. Can't see that. this day and age, that these guys now look back on their careers and going, Jesus, what a fucking, I got paid to waste my time. We made no difference whatsoever.
None. Absolutely.
All you did was take it out of the hands of three generations of people that did
putting
it
somebody else.
And not fired one fucking shot at you and turned it over to the cartels in Mexico. But they don't want Colombian weed anymore, so they want to sell the Mexican brickweed shit. So the Colombian weed goes to North Africa and into Europe at that point. So in comes a guy like our buddy, our boy Al, who can, you know, find me that rare strain of the shit we used to bring, that Colombian red shit, man.
Apparently that dude knows the guy who knows a guy who's heard a rumor that there was possibilities.
Since, like, when was I first here last? In June or something?
Man, I think that must have been last. We got the keys to here, what, August? So you were here August or September or some shit at that point.
My first live episode, yeah.
Oh, the live episode? Yeah. Live episode, a lot of shit earlier in there.
That's when I heard the shit about the Colombian strain of the red bud that I used to bring in.
And yeah.
By the boatloads, man. I would love to smell and taste that again. Oh, my God.
Well, it's, in theory, if anybody who might have the ideas on that, it might be the alchemist, I'll tell you what.
Al's the one that brought it up, man. He said, damn, the boat. You know, well, you can smoke something.
You can read all about the Colombian Red in the book, Saltwater Cowboy, that my man over there is about to hold
up.
The Rise and Fall of Marijuana Empire by our bud Tim McBride from Barnes & Noble, Amazon, Indigo, Audible.com, better bookstores and head shops. And you can get an autographed copy from me as soon as Annette gets the links up.
Yeah, cool.
Other than that,
man, it's always cool being back here, man.
All my other guests have come and gone throughout the show. You want to just hang out for me and close this out? Perfect. All this way, sit back, smoke. So we do some dabs. There's some turp fire over there in those green jars.
Finally going to offer me a freaking dab, dude.
Help yourself, bro. I want to get that out of the way before I lost you.
I had dabs. My first dab in 14, almost 15 hours just a little while ago, man. And then on the world, all of a sudden it made sense again.
You come to the right place, man. Studio 7-10.
I know I have. And my
we'll
buddy
take
Parker.
Good care of you, brother. Welcome back.
Parker, we're hanging right, bro.
You do know that, but did you know? Yeah, I'll take the other one. Yeah. Okay, dokey. That is, my friend, that is the Lost Coast OG from Turp Fire. Tim McBride's about to get in on Sublimator, making it happen. The guys are getting ready to peace out for sound check. Appreciate you hanging in here. We're getting in the home stretch of the show anyway.
Close to. No, shit. We got some shit to go. Yikes, I better hurry the fuck up. Okay, so every week, more random trivia, odd facts, weird tips, useless info, connection to our guest this week. Did you know, according to the Outlaws, aka the Outlaw Immortals, a hip-hop group formed by Tupac, obviously worked with Daz and Slum Rec and Mac Sean, that they mixed the created remains of Tupac Shakur with marijuana and smoked the concoction at a memorial service for the slain rapper. Apparently the impetus for sparking the Pac blunt, as they say, came from the song Black Jesus, in which he referred, which the rapper said, last witch wishes, and then a word I can't really say, smoke my ashes. So, they maybe took the inspiration from that and said it's true. So Mac, Sean, and Daz, of course, worked with Tupac back in the day and could probably confirm it for us if I asked them. We didn't get to that. But the Outlaws did confirm it on multiple different occasions. The family, though, they have not confirmed it.
I've heard this very thing.
Yes, but a lot of people have. But so this one might be one you may have heard of, but still, I just thought there was the connection, so it was an easy throw to it this week. You know, easy, low-hanging stuff. It was like, it was free content. What do you want? And speaking of free, I know what you want. Yes, sir. Puff, puff, pass it along. One of your favorite segments, for sure. I wish I could do it every week, but you know, shipping is expensive, and on and on, and this all adds up. We'll get it all there one day. Anyway, that said, we're doing it again for the first time in a number of weeks, six of them to be exact, because you know, kind of on rotation. I got all this weed here, which is lovely. I don't want to not have the weed here, because people like the weed. You know, it's nice to see bags of weed on the table, but I got so much stuff I'm gonna have to put on the table here. Slide a little bit to the side. Just slide it to the, my Christmas decorations. It's okay, just slide them. Okay. Puff, puff, passing along. I give away a bunch of stuff to some lucky winner that can be, or answer some question, or do some random thing, and I kind of liked it. Kind of liked it. We did the closest to, and the answer was like 427 or something. I think Parker's trying to get in or out. I think I heard the door. and so people were guessing for, not that it, I deliberately made it 427, I just thought I heard, I just happened to come out of that. Anyway, it was 420, a couple people voted, but one person in true Price is Right fashion voted 421. So we're gonna see how it goes down today.
Went off the rail just a hair, right? So, snuck in.
Got a big prize pack this week here. And I'm gonna also default and say this. From the get-go, I reserve the right to, if it does not all fit in the box that I get, and I'm gonna get the biggest of the photo flat pack boxes, it's cool, and I can fit quite a bit in there, and I'll pack it as smart as I can. However, if for some reason I can't get all of this shit in the box, I'm not gonna put it all in there. And you're just not gonna get a couple of them. And I'm not gonna send multiple. It's free, and take it. So, and you like it. And also, this would also be the point where, again, I couldn't really do interview the dog pound wearing a Santa suit and shit. And also, Santa X, I heard, was busy this year before there's too many things to do. So he figured that he could anoint me as Elf X, which we didn't do a lower third for, luckily. Hi. Yeah. Right? So this is for the Santa costume, sort of type of Christmassy environmental, there you go. The Elf costume, making it happen. Yeah, no.
Got to have the pointy shoes, man. To
yeah, no, I can't do it. Can't do it. You get the gist of it. We'll call it Christmas decorations. Before Todd puts a picture of it on fucking Instagram, I got to get that going. That said, I'll probably still get a screen grab and fuck with me. But we're giving away a fair bit of shit this week. So speaking of hats and toques, though, let's just get right into it. Smoking. Why not? Smoking, you know, I fuck with smoking. And, perfect, we on this one? Okay, so, yeah, you know, I mess with smoking, so I got a few items from them, and they're not on the show all the time, but you don't always see my stuff on the show. That looked a little out of focus. Looks like it's getting better. There you go.
Nice.
We got Todd on the camera holding it down today. He's multitasking today. Bam, so we got that. While we're talking smoking stuff, because you like it, I may as well get all that out of the way. We got this little tin of smoking mints. That easy.
and one of the coveted smoking ashtrays, as well as there's also a tin over here, and a little container for your little stash container-y sort of stuff. That one's pretty cool. And, oh, just like I use, one of the rolling trays. I think there's another one, was another one on the table, but got ganked.
Somebody copped it.
Ganked by the fucking dog pound. Dog pound lighter gankers.
Dude, you leave a lighter sitting around.
Right?
It has your shit on it, or some shit like this.
Luckily, there's another one in the top desk drawer.
It's gone.
Right? Gah! Not my TCC letter. You can't have it. But you can't have all this. But wait, there's more. So we got all this one to start out with. Well, TCC.
I'm digging
letter,
a hat.
Right? You're going to need that one.
I'm going to need a hat.
Speaking of hats, Flight, while we're on toques and hats and stuff, Flight sent us another toque and hat. We'll get the toque-y sort of headwear out of the way. So Flight sent over the hat. There was a box, but Todd's been messing around with all my stuff all weekend and moving shit that I had, like, lined up. I had a box of pens that were all nicely positioned on the table. I don't know. There was a box of Flight thing.
It is an actual fact that the expert does have his shit together.
Yeah, there was a box. We'll see if we can find it later. Maybe it's still in my office. I don't know where we can go to. But there was a Flight pen distillate thingy. I'll see if I've got it somewhere still. It was set out. But it's okay. We'll see if we can find it. And a couple of cartridges that are supposed to go with that pen. That's in there as well, too. And a little lanyard to go with that. And a little Flight dab tool. With that. So that's part of a little Flight package. And yeah, there's supposed to be a little clear plastic box. Not 100% sure where that has ended up, but it was around, and we'll see if we can find it.
It's clear, you can't see it.
Yeah, right? I don't know. Okay. Oh yeah, I also forgot for the smoky papers. It threw me off as well, too. We got the box of rollies. No, I don't know. It was with all the rest of the prizes for all the stuff. Well, I'll take a look for it later. Anyway, I'll see if I can find it. Maybe I have an extra one. I don't know. There was one here at one point. Moving forward, though. Miss Envy. Headwear. Keeping it on headwear. Miss Envy sent over this hat. Very nice hat. And while we're on Miss Envy, this is like a top and bottom ladies' underwears. Nice little gray set of clothing. So you can have that. Also a sweatshirt from Miss Envy, kind of adding up quickly. They've got these nice Nug shirts, very nice. Ooh, nice Nugs. And
Miss Envy was very cool. I had some of that stuff last time I was here.
Nice. The In Buddha We Trust logo here. Now if you go to the missenvy.ca website, you can actually see some of the pictures with some of the new gear and clothes. And old Slapnuts over here. Fucking around, making an ass of himself on the what to buy section. And I'm gonna see if I can impromptu pull this up without it making the world explode. But it is, it's cool. Another one of these t-shirts. And Thompson Caribou, speaking of t-shirts, shouts to the Squid Odd. They got one of their Thompson Caribou t-shirts here for me right now. Throwing that in the apparel. There's the link. And while we're on apparel, oh no, wait, still Miss Envy. No, we got off that. TCC. Well, it started with Miss Envy. Back to Miss Envy. We got a couple of pins from Miss Envy. One of the nice Nug pins and the nice Nug shirts. It's hard to see through the plastic, but they're there. They're cool. They look better. Oh yes, Andrew. To the computer, if I can, in just a second. Yes, you see in the clothing. Look at this fucking dummy. It's the same shirt, but it's not the same shirt that I was wearing. It's just a shirt like it. Yeah, I know. Yeah, fuck this guy. Let's go ahead and get a thumbs down on this one. No, but let's get a thumbs up for all the rest of the ladies. And so yeah, this outfit there that lovely Camila is wearing is what this gray thing is here.
I can see it.
Which
now
looks way better on the lovely Camila.
That bag doesn't do it any justice.
Doesn't do it much justice, no. But in just a poor attempt at ratings, we've gone ahead and shown her looking lovely. And mostly me looking goofy. But anyway, that's cool. As well, clothing, no Miss Envy. These little filter tips. They're like the little glass tips for joints and shit if you're into those.
And, oh, this is a good one.
I have a couple of those.
Yeah, this is the 3-to-1 solventless tincture. This is that's pretty cool. And this is the THC oil, 1,000 milligrams. So both of those from Miss Envy. Mm-hmm. So that's pretty mm. cool.
That's a pile of stuff.
Right? Oh, and a couple CBD caps. But wait, there's more. let's get the clothing out of the way because it's big. This is a hoodie from 91 Supreme. Shout out to the guys from 91 Supreme on the show last week doing it. Sorry, Weed. You're going to have to move for just a minute. I don't know where else to put you, Doug. And while we're on 91 Supreme, a couple of 91 Supreme dab mats for everybody. Yeah, I know. Damn, right? Chilling like a villain? It keeps going and going. And from 91 Supreme also as well, too. A gram of the hard-to-read shatter. The color is not easy to see on here. The Sensi Star Shatter. There you go. That's nice. Pretty cool.
Nice.
And a dab tool from Courtney. From Courtney Made It. So you can use it to dab with. That's super dope.
I saw those on her Instagram.
Yeah, right? She's murder with it.
Yep.
And then also this pendant that she made on the show as well, too. So shouts to Courtney Made It. What else? Oh, yeah. Enlightened Edibles made these. These are some cookies. Various sorts. We got some chocolate chip cookies. And we got some lemon eruption cookies from the guys at Enlightened Edibles, your sugar-free bakery. So if sugar's not your thing, if it's too much, can't do sugar, then you might want to check out the Enlightened Edibles guys. That's actually kind of a good feature for some people because they don't necessarily want sugar, right?
So right.
Can't have it or whatever. So if you need a diabetic-friendly sort of option, that's something you can check out, which is dope. And also, speaking of dope, Green Society. A little bit of dope from Green Society. I think it's one large bag of Blue Dream that was opened and sampled. And then the other jar or bag of that I think might be Blue Dream as well, but I could be wrong, but it hasn't been opened. It's not labeled. So Mystery Weed from Green Society, checking them out. All these very good things. Now, again, one of these hats might not fit in or some of the sweatshirt might be a little big, but I'm going to work on it. I think I can make most of it happen here. That is the plan to give away. And on top of that as well, too, also dope, Alex Mars CD, for anybody who's still got a CD player or can find a way to download it off their computer some way, shape, form, I don't know. But it's here and it's for you as well too, thrown in the kit. And there is an approximate retail value for all of this that, well, is what we're going to figure out. That's the whole point of Puff Puff passing along.
It's a pile of stuff, I'll give you right? that.
It's a big fucking pile, man. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna set the timer on my clock here, on my official clocky McClockersons, the iPhone clock. We're gonna go on. It won't read my thumbprint because I got too much residue on my thumbs. So
it won't drag across the glass.
Right. The where is the timer here? So I'm gonna go set my timer, and I'm gonna go give it. I don't know. What do you think? 3 minutes? 2 minutes?
How long does it take to come up with a number?
Well, we got a few people here to guess and stuff like that. So we'll give 2 minutes. 2.5 minutes. Split the difference. You get 2.5 minutes. Because why not?
Price is right.
It's being different. So what we're going to do is over in the Facebook chat and in the YouTube chat, I'm going to type the word start. And then the clock, I'm going to start the clock over here. And then when this clock is done over here, I'm going to press stop on the Facebook chat. And I'm going to stop on the YouTube chat. And then from there, I'm going to see who got the closest to without going over. Okay? Okay? You got to make that very clear. If you're over by a dollar and you're the closest to, still, you don't win. It's Price is Right rules. So closest to without going over. And on that note, don't start voting yet. Save your votes, Wild Dragon. Save your votes. Don't jump the gun yet. I haven't said start, so none of these votes count. Okay? On both platforms.
Wait for the freaking gun to go off.
Wait for me to say go. But I didn't say go yet, so wait. Two rules. One, you got to be over the age of 19 because there's weed in here. And two, you got to be in Canada because there's weed in here and I'm not shipping the shit internationally.
And I ain't taking it home for you.
Right, so it's not happening. So the only stupid rules that they are is you got to be 19 and in Canada to enter. So I said, Brighton Wilson, I said, don't start entering yet. Just wait. I know. Well, people don't have CD players anymore. I don't know, Forrest Walker. If they don't, I might have the USB that I could send you instead if you would prefer it, or if there's not enough room in the box. Okay, so we'll see. We'll see. But the, yes, so we're going to make you go ahead and start voting for these in just a second. But the point is, I do want to thank everybody who made this happen and all the companies who've been on the show and been associated with the show and sponsoring the show and making it all part possible, who give you all this stuff to give away, like Smoking, Alex Marr, Green Society, 91 Supreme, Flight, Miss Envy, Enlightened Edibles, Roll Your Own, who actually is through Smoking, you know that guy and those guys. Courtney Made It, Thompson Caribou, much love from all these folks. And on the late ad, I can probably even throw in one of these Turp Fire ones just as a, because of why not, there's one sitting here. I'm sure Ryan won't shit on me. I love it. So that is the package. So that is pretty much it. So yes, again, 19 and in Canada are the only two rules I got right now. But if you're not over the age of 19 and you don't live in Canada, please don't like just throw numbers out in the chat. Because I want to pick somebody who I can actually send this to and not waste it, and then have to go back and pick someone else, and it's a fucking pain in the ass.
That would suck.
Right? It fucking slows down the whole show, and we're already running late as it is. And I got to go host another show here in like fucking 3 hours, okay? I got to go do this fucking thing at Fortune, if you hadn't heard by now. So, here's the deal. 19 and Canadian, that's it. It's your only two, not that fucking hard. For that, you get $1 worth of shit. But now you're gonna guess on how much this shit is worth. That's a big fucking pile. You don't get the weed though. Just the, this thing's in here. Not the hair. And not the hair, just the here. without going over to those over the age of 19 in Canada, when I say start and you see the start pop up in the chat, you can vote the first one to get it closest to without going over in 3, 2, 1, go. And go. Okay, so boom. Everybody's going. My timer's going. The Cannabis Culture chat room feature Dealey says start. And Pot TV says start. So I'm not going to sit here and watch the chat the whole time. I do know the value of it. The actual retail value of a lighter would be about $1 million right now. There's one there. There's probably one more in my top drawer. So you've got exactly 2 minutes to continue your votes. Okay, get your votes in if you're over the age of 19 and live in Canada only on Facebook or on YouTube. You've got just that amount of time. How much is this big pile of stuff from all of these wonderful people worth? Miss Envy, 91 Supreme, Green Society, Courtney Made It, Alex Marr, TCC, Flight, Enlightened Edibles, Smoking, Roll Your Own, and now even with a late ad, Turp Fire. So many tings in the box today. This big box that's behind the this box right here. You've got a minute and 25 seconds to get in your votes if you're over the age of 19 and in Canada. What is the actual retail value without going over for this big ass prize? And I tell you, it is a substantial prize. This stuff is not cheap, and there's a lot of it. And as you can see, Parker could not care less. There's not one carrot, not one bone treat, not one liver in there. There is nothing, so Parker is not interested. I tell you, though, if you're voting less than last time, that probably would not make sense because there is more gear than last time. Al the Alchemist is still here. Are they at soundcheck? Are you at soundcheck?
Soundcheck's at 7.
So everyone's just running around, standing around, having a good time?
They're going to go chill for a little bit.
And this is hotbox their hotel room? Sounds like a wonderful idea. Nice. All right, so we got 30 seconds. Don't relax. Get your numbers in now. You've got just that amount of time to figure out what this value is if you're over the age of 19, living in Canada. This is a lot of fucking stuff. Please believe. Just 15 seconds. All right, guys. Getting it down to it, so I'm going to type...
The bombardment of subtle hints.
Just, right? I can't tell you enough. This is going to end soon. We've got just seconds away.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
There you go. Stop, stop, stop in the chat. Stop in the everything. Stop in the boom, 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 boom. All right. So we've got our last votes in, before and after. You can stop voting now. That's it. The time is done. I put stop in the chat room in each of them. No more votes count. So save your fingers. You will need them for rolling joints. Put them to better use. There you go. All right. So let's go back and take a look. As I said, first person who got it closest to without going over. Now this is going to take a second to take a look in the Facebook chat, so I'm going to start with the YouTube one because it's a little bit easier. $1, Craig, that's a good vote. That is a good vote, but I'm going to say that's not quite the same. No, that will not be the most. It's a safe vote, but all right.
For sure.
Where is the start of this? Dude, big Christmas prize, that's right here. Come on down. Dun, 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 dun. Where did I say start? Ready, where did I start?
Balor will get you the bag that hoodie's in.
You know what I mean? So, okay, look at you. This is so boring for you to sit here and watch me scroll numbers. Scrolling, scrolling, scrolling. Don't do, don't do. Okay. Don't do. Okay.
Well, sit here and watch me watch him.
Right? Watch Tim do a dab.
What the fuck?
In the meantime, Tim, do a dab, Tim.
Yeah, why not?
Right? Tim, do something fancy like dabs.
I was just looking.
There's lots of them around.
There's a shit pile.
A large pile of them. Okay. Oh, seen a couple of fairly close.
Gooey. Ooey. Gooey.
And that's where I say stop. Okay, cool. Now, in the even more painful to watch for a second, give me a sec while I load up the chat and have to scroll back in the Facebooks, because this one's slightly annoying as well, too, to redo. So liking, commenting it as sort by here. Okay. 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 Well. Huh. Timmy.
What do you got?
Well, interesting. I don't have anybody who got it bang on. There is not the number bang on.
Well, that wasn't exactly the entire term of the whole thing.
I know, but I'm just gonna say that to start with. Nobody got it first right up.
Cool.
To start with, to go from there.
Yeah, because that's a hell of a pile, man.
That's a big pile. Do you have a guess?
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck no.
No? In Canadian dollars?
I'm sitting here all fucked up, man. You're gonna ask me to guess about that
pile.
Yeah,
how much that worth?
Yeah, I'll throw a dollar out.
Right?
Do your I'll top the last bid. $1.50.
Right? There you go. I do have what I believe here. I'm just going back to check. Now that I've got both of them all where they need to be. One more little cross-reference here. Super entertaining television. Okay, I do have what I believe is the closest vote without going over. I'm going to take one more little last fucking look at this just to be on... prudence sake, if you will, to avoid controversy, which, you know, there's always going to be controversy because someone's going to be upset because it's just how it rolls. Okay. Okay. And then before I say stop, okay. Right. So looking closely, it's a good prize. Tim's right, $1.50. I'm going to tell you right now, Tim, that is not right. That was not quite right. That was not close enough. There was a lot closer votes than that.
You think?
Yeah. So looking at the votes, as I go through, the closest two without going over was, you know, not that far off. Pretty close, within a reasonable amount.
Which is?
Well, I'm about to tell you. But there is one person who in the Facebook chat. And the gift call, Price is Right rules. From the get-go, and said, closest to without going over.
Right.
And some poor motherfucker missed it by $1.
That's great.
Last time in classic Price is Right fashion, we had the perfect Price is Right bid. Now we have the ultimate Price is Right heartbreaker.
Oh, man.
Over with the $1 bid. Now we got the $1 over bid.
Oh, no.
The amount of this total is $1,166.
Wow.
So the winner and the closest bid that I can see in the YouTube chat or the thing without going over is $1,090 by 132454. Now 132454, you need to make sure you're over the age of 19 and Canadian, because that was the default in there. If not, I'll have to try and find someone else, but you need to get back in the chat and confirm that that is you are, and you are can do that before I lose all this chat stuff and pick somebody else because you fucked up my game. So hopefully you listen to the rules from the get-go and you are, and then congratulations!
They were only explained like six times.
Right? Rick Ross, you poor son of a bitch. In Facebook. Now, I've sent you prizes beforehand, so I know it's not like you haven't got prizes.
Do we want to know even the guy that like went over by a buck?
Yeah, that is Rick Ross. Oh, 1167 was his vote.
Bastard. Oh, man. That sucks.
Price is Right rules, homie. I like you. You're a good guy.
Even closer on the top end than the guy was on the bottom end.
I know.
Dude, that's fucked up.
Closest without going over.
But hey.
It is
the congrats to the freaking winner anyways,
man. I can't
go
back on that just because of that. You know, I'm sure Rick Ross will win another one going forward at some point. Rick Ross has won before and probably win again. As a big supporter, I feel bad for Rick, but goddamn.
Damn, man, yeah, that's
how are you going to two times Puff Puff passes along in a row where we've got the crucial Price is Right moment even. Man, that's good television.
Very stimulating.
Wow. So okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5. So you're good to go there. Yes, you are perfect. All right. So then they confirm that. I know that's fucked up, Craig Parker. You ain't lying. I don't disagree with you. I feel bad for my man over there. That is hard. Rick Ross. It's not really the man, but you know, Rick Ross knows. But Rick Ross has won before. Rick Ross will probably get something again. And somewhere along the line, I'll find this flight pen. You know. Damn, that's cold though, but that's Puff Puff.
No, that was very cool though.
That's fair, fair though.
Yeah, it was good, man.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5, 4, 5, 4. Go ahead and either direct message me on Instagram or Twitter with your name and your mailing address, or go ahead and email info@expertjoints.com and you can go ahead, give me that confirmation of your ID, your address, your whatever, just so I know who you are and what's going down, and I'll make sure I get this out to you. Probably be after Christmas or somewhere in the next few days.
Badass box.
Anyway, that's some shit. Right? Wow, man, you can't write that shit.
That's $1,166 Ooh. Bucks worth of shit.
Ooh, not 1167, 1166. That is cold, dude. Man. I feel bad for that dude to some degree, but I do appreciate the loyalty and the following. Don't worry, I'm sure it'll come. What goes around coming around. One before, we'll win again. And that's kind of, you know, how it goes here. We do appreciate Miss Envy, 91 Supreme, Green Society, Courtney Made It, Alex Mark, Thompson Caribou, Flight, Enlightened Edibles, Smoking, Roll Your Own, and even Turb Fire for getting in on the giveaway. That was a lot of fun. I do appreciate everybody who makes that shit happen for us. Man, that was just cold. I also appreciate grassrootsmedicinal.ca, lonetreesconcentrates.ca, topleaf.ca, thompsoncaribou.com, greensociety.ca, and flight.life for helping us make season 3 of Expert Joints Live happen. And with that, Andrew, play some commercials. Support Team Shatterboo and visit thompsoncaribou.com today. Fresh drops every week from the squad.
We get it. You're busy crafting the finest product this land has to offer. But a fine product means fine packaging. You wouldn't get married in a tracksuit, would you? Whether it's extracts, shatter, butter, CBD oil, edibles, or just cannabis, Jade Maple takes care of your fine product with fine design at a fine price. Check out more fine solutions at jademaple.com. British Columbia, home to the most beautiful landscapes in the world. Home to mom and pop vineyards, hot springs, farmers markets, some of the world's best skiing, snowboarding, surfing, and mountain biking. We protect our rainforests and keep our air clean. In BC, we strike the right balance between nature and nurture. But did you know that for the last 30 years, BC has also been home to the finest cannabis in the world? BC Bud is world-renowned for its taste, aroma, and potency. We've competed and won cups,
gained recognition from international celebrities. We are the Cannabis Growers of Canada. We create wealth, opportunity, and good-paying private sector jobs. The BC cannabis crop is worth over $7 billion a year, and there were over 17,000 farms creating work for Canadians and improving the lives of millions of people. We are joining together to build a free and fair cannabis market that benefits all Canadians. Won't you come and join us at cannagrowers.ca?
International with it. It might be Christmas and shit, but you know, we still watch what's going around the world. And a little present to Mexico. Mexico is going to legalize marijuana-based product sales next year. It has been confirmed. We've touched on it a little bit going forward, who and what they might do. Let me zoom this in so you can see just a little bit better with the text. Mexico will legalize sales of marijuana-based medicines, foods, drinks, cosmetics, and other products early next year, its health regulator said on Wednesday, bringing some forms of cannabis into legal commerce, even as the country struggles with the illicit drug trade. So, whether Jeffrey, your buddy Mr. Sessions down there, likes it or not, he's going to be flanked on both sides by the cannabises.
Absolutely.
Uh-oh.
Wake the fuck up.
Right? You may as well get in there while you fit in there. You heard of NAFTA, right?
We're
going to amend that in a minute. And speaking of little amendments and things from you know, legal type of folks political type folks.
Here's your boy.
Right? Yeah, not my buddy. Justin Trudeau says cannabis will become legal next summer, not July 1st. My man, in a fucking, giving himself some fucking breathing room, says, Prime Minister Justin Trudeau says next summer and not July 1st is the date cannabis will become legal across the country. So experts of an interview Trudeau gave to the TVA network in Quebec were broadcast Tuesday with a full interview to be shown Wednesday night. So this is a couple days ago. Trudeau shook his head when interviewer asked him why he was so obsessed with July 1st as the date for cannabis legalization to become law. Prime Minister said it would not be July 1st, but that it would be for next summer. The date will not be July 1st, I can assure you of that. I don't know where that date come from. So really, he then gets from somewhere in late June till somewhere in late September. So July, August, early September or late...
Pick a day, dude. Right?
Somewhere, stay tuned for more and or more backpedaling. Health Canada nearly doubles number of licensed marijuana production licenses in the second half of 2017 because they're scaling up thinking that somewhere in the summer, maybe July 2nd, maybe June 30th, but not July 1st. Probably. Anyway, Health Canada says that of December 1st, 208 applicants were in the final stages of the approval process. Wow, that's a lot of folks trying to get into it. But they're doubling it, yes, obviously in the rush trying to get towards it. The dramatic surge in approved and aspiring producers comes in the wake of the agency's concerted efforts to loosen its bureaucratic approval process and head off what experts fear may be a looming supply crunch for the burgeoning legal cannabis market? Wow, experts told you that, hey?
That was a mouthful.
Wow. Another expert's also saying that Canadians are spending nearly as much on marijuana as wine, shows a report, which is probably they're trying to scale up productions. Wow. Justin Trudeau is committed to legalizing recreational cannabis, so why not recreational wine? We spent $6.2 billion on marijuana in 2015, they say, almost as much as we did on wine, where they spent just more than a couple of points extra in percentage. It was crazy. $7.4 billion or something. So just about on point, we drink almost as much wine as we do smoke cannabis as Canadians. So yes, you're probably going to need to double your production once it's legal, because if we're smoking that amount that you know about that's supposedly illegal or medical, you got another thing coming. And also in big news and crazy numbers that make no sense, and good luck with that. Not for these people, but for the government, and good luck with that government. getting $400,000 out of Mark and Jody Emery. They were fined nearly $400K, $395,000 in the court case. In the positive note, 17 cannabis culture employees' charges were completely dropped against for over 180 counts. I think they accepted two plea counts. Chris and Aaron Goodwin, Brittany Anguera, all three also pleaded guilty and got various different forms of probation. Chris got a $13,000 fine, Brittany a $13,000 fine, Aaron a $3,900 fine. They're on probation for 24 months. Jody and I, or sorry, probation for 24 months are Jody and Mark, and 18 months for Brittany, Chris, and Aaron. And Jody and Mark have to pay $195,000 in fines each or go to jail for every 120 bucks. $5 an hour. No, whatever that is. That's not right. You know, yeah, $5 an hour.
Yeah.
So that was some of the things that made the news. Also in the news is what's going on with Expert Joints. And well, that's when Andrew rolls the updates video. Yeah, but it's also Mark offered to go to jail and they said that's not an option. But there, and then it's also said it's not something that they're prisonable for. But and Mark's already claimed that he won't be able to pay that within the next fucking 2 years or whatever the thing is. That's kind of ridiculous. So
right.
Anyway, there'll be more to hear about that, I'm sure, and watch the rest of the Pot TV shows for, I'm sure, much more coverage tomorrow on Cannabis Culture News. Yikes. And watch the replay yesterday of Greg's show and all that stuff. anyway, as for me, on Sunday we released two new articles from James and Ashley Priest of Canalance, The Gift of Ganja, and We Are the Champions, thanks to expert contributors James and Ashley.
Story.
Yeah.
On me.
Yeah, I know. That's how we first met.
Very cool people.
James did a story on you. And
very
actually,
cool people.
James and I are going to have a chat coming up soon, talk good about new things for 2018 and moving forward. So awesome. Please support them at Canna Lance across social media and canna-lance.com. Also, we reposted the Cannabis Life Network article of the video recap that we watched last week about the Emerald Cup from expertjoints.com and Mike Okaida's, or Kaida, Mike. Mike's article from the event recap as well, too. So make sure you go back and check that out. You can obviously see it at Cannabis Life Network, or you can check it out at expertjoints.com as well. Watch the replay on the YouTubes and then everywhere on my show. It's fun. Good times. Thanks again to the Emerald Cup and to Mike and CLN for making all that shit happen. Also on Sunday, I was at the Dope Magazine Awards in Seattle with my guest Courtney Dabswell from Weed Maps. Shouts to Courtney and shouts to David Tran and the whole team for having a great party. And a wonderful night. I did have to cut out kind of early because I had a 3-hour drive back home, which I got home at like 2 o'clock in the morning and worked till like 4 in the morning, which was early in comparison to last night, which I worked till 5 in the morning. But here we are doing it. Yes, I was tweeting to you, sending you messages as he was on the flight waiting for him to land. And oh yes, good times had by all. But we're getting it all done. It's been a busy, busy week. But as for next week, it's our last show of 2017.
You do get around.
Yeah, I do. I cover a bit of distance. I'd like to cover some more if other companies out there want to do some collaborative, some other media stuff. We do some, you know, cross more content and some other media platforms. But I assume that will all happen too. So you'll see me around. You can see a big bag of weed on someone's doorstep. Well, not a big bag of weed. Big bag of products on somebody's doorstep pretty soon too. You can barely see me behind it. If I was Jer, it'd look like this.
It's a big pile.
speaking of Jared, watch his show Friday, of course, tomorrow, Cannabis Culture News. The Royal Hour with Kush, no, the Royal Hour with, no, that's not right. High Noon with Alyssa Miles and the rest of the crew. High Noon on Sunday is the show. Of course, Alyssa's show is Saturday. We've got weekend programming. Cushy show is 2 o'clock, Alyssa's show is at 12 o'clock. The 420 Lifestyle with Carly Marley and BC Bud Gals is on Mondays. And Wednesdays, Man Ali Alchemist, Greg and Cushy, all doing it from under the influence. We're obviously under the influence here. Trying to wrap it up as quick
very
as
cool
I can.
Stuff.
Saltwater Cowboy, appreciate you being here,
yeah, man.
I appreciate the fact that, well, next week, let me get that good. That's a nice little shot there. And,
that's the first thing I noticed when I walked through
right?
the door,
hey,
man.
Of course you do. Big bag of weeds.
It goes with all the Christmas
right?
stuff, man. Little buds, little nugs.
You're gonna still gonna be in town next week, so you'll be here. Come out.
Yeah, man.
Hang with us. Great.
Yeah, sure.
Saltwater Cowboy's gonna be here next week. Also, Dabber Man, he's gonna be in town as well, too. Haven't seen him in a minute, so he'll be back hanging
that
out with us.
That would be very cool.
And who else hasn't been with us in a while? Loudonio
Yes, Jenny's going to come and join us as well, too. Come hang out with us for the day. And even somebody else, taking it back even further, our girl Stormy Ent is going to come through, who's having surgery today, so be able to finally hook up with her again, bring her back on the show. It's going to be a gang of weed.
Very cool, man.
The gang's going to be all here, and we'll see who else can come through. It's kind of like a little New Year's episode party. We got people in town and friends and family, so make sure you choke up and tune in. It should be fun. Nice. Get you all some of these products. So many of them to have. This is all going out in the mail order, yes. We'll have some products on the show. We'll be plenty plenty sauced up, I'm sure, in the sauce.
And I got to give another, you know, shout-out prop to my man Steve Butterking.
Butterking, if he wants to come through, maybe bring some fine products with him. Kush Cream wants to come through. All these folks, I'm sure there'll be a good time having our sort of New Year's close-out. But there's also going to be a bunch of weed.
You surround yourself by a bunch of very cool people, man.
Yeah, we try, I gotta give it.
That's why I always come back here, man.
Dude, well, you're a very cool person and a legend in the weed game. And I've interviewed a lot of folks, but I can't lie. I mean, Daz Dillinger is... Although Raekwon, I did technically get on a 420 episode, and I've interviewed him before, and I've interviewed Damian Marley and Plug 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 and Burner and all these guys. But as far as technically like the most famous person, probably internationally known, for the longest known, to been in the studio or on the show set yet, probably Daz Dillinger. So that's pretty cool, man.
Yeah.
So that's show.
It's awesome.
Right? I listened to that cat for a long time. I'm trying to be cool about it. But, you know, shit, that's fucking neat, man. What are you going to say? Also, next week's episode will be a lot of fun. So toke up and tune in. Thanks for everybody who's making it happen. Daz Dillinger, Salam Rec, Max Sean, appreciate you all being here. Also, Creed Taylor, all performing in just a couple hours at Fortune Sound Club. I got to go home. I should have wrapped this up a long time ago. I got to take Parker home. I got to get some food. I gotta get ready. The event starts at like fucking 9 or some shit. I gotta be down there to host that. I wanted to nap. I don't think it's gonna happen.
Good luck with that one.
Right. I also gotta thank Ryan from Terp Fire for the dabs and Temple of Calyx for all the weed we smoked.
Yeah, these are
on
great.
The event tonight.
These dabs are good.
Right. Thanks for letting me host it, Al, and arranging, obviously, because of his event. I got the interview. So thanks, Holmes. Also, thanks to everybody who's watching. Teresa Marshall, Chilling Like a Villain, NH, what are you saying? Teresa Marshall, Bree S, everybody who's here doing it. We appreciate you guys being here and watching. Richard Middleton, you over there in the Facebook chat. I see you being in the place to be. Mm-hmm. We thank you very much, Bree S. I appreciate the kind words, making it happen. Congratulations again to 1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1. Rick Ross, call him over in the Facebook chat for a come on, bro, hook me up. You know what, man? I have hooked you up before on some shit like that. I even think you've won a consolation prize or some shit before. Someone else, you got the prize and someone else got a consolation. There's been controversy surrounding a win with you before. You know, it is the holidays. Hit me up on the DM. I might be able to slide something your way. We'll see how it goes, B. But Merry Christmas to everybody who's been in the place. We appreciate it. Andrew, thank you so much for the help. This has to have been one of the wildest episodes you've had to juggle with yet. Yeah, nodding in the booth.
Been Todd, a riot, man.
Thank you so much, Todd. Appreciate it over there. Tanya, we're almost done. I know you want to get out. We're trying to make it happen. This is a lot fucking episode to manage. I did not intend it to be this long, but hey, when you get a moment like this, you take it. You never know what's going to happen live here on Pod TV, and you never know what will happen next week for episode 116. If I may, Andrew, would you please hit the music?